had enough of this palaver. Let's get the show on the road.
Let's. It's on the road. There it is. Just got on the on-ramp. Accelerating into traffic. Oh, there's someone jamming on the brakes in front of us. Oh, damn it.
Nothing but red lights ahead. We might as well hang out here and talk a little while. Opie and Anthony, good morning.
Is it two for Tuesday already? Nice.
Yeah, it is. Already. One, we were here one day.
Yeah, but that works, trust me.
Yeah, it really does. Get that Monday out of the way, kind of.
Yeah, Monday sucks.
It does kind of work.
Monday sucks no matter what you do for a living.
We're lucky. I hear ya.
We're lucky, but it still sucks for even us.
Yeah.
And we got cool jobs.
Getting up thing that sucks.
Last night was one of those nights where that fine lightning wakes you up.
I didn't hear any of that shit.
I think it hit you right around
Long Island.
Was it raining when you came in?
Pouring out.
That's why, because it was slowly but surely making its way to Long Island. But
pouring.
All of a sudden, you're fast asleep, and all of a sudden you're awake, and you're like, "Why am I awake?" And then, bam! Oh, that's why I'm awake. Lightning storms.
All I know is driving in on the, I guess, the south side of the Long Island Expressway in Queens. It looked like an explosion. Looked like a mushroom cloud.
Really? What's that about?
I don't know, but there was a big-ass fire cooking somewhere. Did you see that, Danny?
No.
Was it a car fire?
No, couldn't have been. It was too big.
Huh. Why isn't the news covering it?
I don't know. I was driving by, and I had winds on. It looked like it just happened,
Long Island?
It was. Queens.
Oh, yeah, it was a wig factory.
A wig factory? Yeah, that'll happen. I smell burning hair. Was it Ted's Wig Emporium and Toop and Wig Emporium?
I had a wig store. It didn't do well. The only person I bawled him after was Yul Brynner.
He was bald.
Could you imagine a wig freaking factory going up with real hair burning for everybody?
Ugh. That smell.
What is going on today? Well, we walked into the studio and we got great news. Great news. SaveTheTitMonster.com is up and running.
Up and running.
Who gives a shit about everything else going on in the world? We got SaveTheTitMonster.com.
This is...
I thought it was going to be that a certain person died.
I think we need other pictures of girls that are well endowed on the site, by
really?
The way. Yeah. I mean, we're trying to save the young tennis player. She's a phenom, but her big boobies are getting in the way.
But it's all about her.
I know, but you gotta
I think we gotta
boost it a little bit.
Keep it about her, though.
Oh, it'll definitely be about her, but maybe some other women with big boobs.
You say take a site dedicated to one person or one thing, and then just turning it into something else.
I'm just thinking a little variety where we get to see more girls with big boobs.
Oh, see, I thought it was something else.
We'll never move away from the reason why we have saved the titmonster.com. But she's a terrific tennis player, but her boobs are getting in the way, and now she's thinking about getting a breast reduction.
Yeah.
That never works, man. You look like the scarring, and it just looks horrendous. You ever see a girl that had her boobs done?
I have never seen boob reduction boobs.
What's the difference?
But I'm sure I will in a second.
They got a cut all over the place. I think it starts with like a cross below the nipple,
really?
And then they bring in, then they have to cut on the sides and move it all together. It's horrific. There you go.
Oh my God. Well, those are awful.
Well,
yep.
That whole thing is awful.
Yeah, they don't know really how to make them look really good after they,
Let's see. There's got to be one good
one. Take out some of the meat.
I dated a girl years ago, a really sexy girl, and she had those scars.
Oh, my God.
She had reduction surgery.
Yeah, see?
Really?
Yeah, I didn't know what it was. She told me like she was really self-conscious about her tits. And it was like that little cross scar. It went from the nipple under, and it didn't look like a typical breast job. And I think that's what it was.
It's a massive scar that starts at the nipple and goes downward.
It's got to be something that... All right, wait, look at that one.
Not too bad.
That's a little better.
I guess it depends on the doctor.
Yeah. Wow, those are awful moose noses beforehand. Jesus.
That's the best description of big boobs ever. Hey, Danny, so SaveTheTitMonster.com. What do we get? What do we get for our money if we go there?
Well, you get to sign a petition to save the tit monster. You could read all about her, why, you know, the site's purpose. Mm-hmm. It's got a message to give to all the people.
Of course, why wouldn't it?
There's Simona News, and we even embedded that YouTube video. So
very
you can
good.
Go and watch her big titties.
Oh, right,
her.
Yeah.
This would get national attention if we didn't call it SaveTheTitMonster.com.
I know.
We're such idiots.
We really are, because it would. They would pick up on it.
They really would.
But a website, forget it. They can't even bother. Do this story.
It is the smartest idea ever, but they don't know how to name their website.
Who is it? Opie and it makes sense. Forget it. Don't even talk about them. Leave them alone. Maybe they'll go away.
We're on a good roll with Breitbart, but I don't think Breitbart's going to pick up the SaveTheTitMonster.com idea.
I don't think they're going to run with this one.
No. They already have a problem playing our audio up there. They have to warn everyone that there's a lot of curses.
Oh, so. Very graphic indeed.
But I think a section with other women to look at, somehow subtly.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I have such a problem logging into my email.
Oh, boy, that's not good. Not in this day and age. So what do we get? We get the petition. We get the news. We get the, photos?
That's coming.
And the embedded video, like you were
saying. Yeah, like, there's going to be pictures.
It's coming!
There's going to be pictures and stuff on that page. But for now, because it's still under construction.
Okay.
So for now, you get the nice big booby video.
What about the background just being big-breasted women?
Might be a little noisy.
I know. It's nothing wrong with noise women. When you're talking about big boobs. So do yourself a favor and check out SaveTheTitMonster.com.
Sign the petition, everyone. Let's save her.
How are we saving her if she really wants this done? We have to explain to her somehow why she needs to keep her really nice boobs. Maybe there should be a comment section.
Comments?
Kind of like an old school guest book.
Something like that.
Yeah, where you sign it and you're able to... All right. Yeah.
Well, like I said, it's a work in progress.
I like it so far.
We could always add to it.
I love it so far, actually.
Wouldn't.
I'll get on that.
We have Bob in Delaware. His girlfriend had the breast reduction surgery.
Hey there, Bab.
Bobby.
Yellow.
Hey, Bob, what's up?
There it is.
What's going on?
Hey.
Sorry.
Hey, man.
I was banging a girl in college that had a breast reduction. Honestly, it made her 100 times better looking because pictures of her beforehand, ooh.
Pretty
they were
bad.
Just so huge. They're just, you know, how do you know this girl that plays tennis, how do you know that, you know, they're not sloppy when she takes off her bra?
There's a few.
They could be pretty nasty.
No, there's a few shots when she leans over to do the serve thing and they're barely moving. She's got youth on her side, my friend. She's 17 years old.
That's true.
I think she should keep playing tennis until she's about 22, 23.
Yeah.
Then maybe some of that gravity will start taking over. I don't know. Mm-hmm. I don't know when that happens.
They are wrapped up in that sports bra, too, you got to remember.
They're pushed nicely to her body.
Oh, my God. Remember that one shot where it's almost squeezing out the armpit? Wonderful.
The scar's pretty bad.
Yeah, the scars are bad, but in the end, you were very happy with how your girlfriend looked, huh?
A lot better. Yeah, because I saw pictures of her previous. I mean, I only met her in college after she had it done, but I saw pictures of her beforehand.
Yeah.
And she just looked completely disproportionate. I mean, it was nasty.
Okay. There you go. Bob's a fan of the reduction. So I guess you're not going to SaveTheTitMonster.com then.
I might. I don't know. You're telling me you thought
I might. You know, you got to talk me into it.
I think this is an excuse, like, for the guys out there that can't really, like, you know, do some porn searching there.
Yeah, to just go there and
go, look, I'm doing something nice here.
It's a cause, honey. Come on, dear. It's a cause.
Hey, maybe that's the deal, Dan. We show really bad breast reduction photos.
Sure. Maybe we get some of those scarring pictures.
That,
up there.
See? That's a good idea because it ties in. That's a great idea. Say, is this what you want? Is this what you want?
And if we do that, then it leads to what I really want. See, you show the pictures of the bad
Cox
scars.
On there?
No. When you see the bad scars, then you go, why look like this when you could look like this? And then well-endowed.
Oh, and then well-endowed girls that are fine.
Yeah. Like left side bad, see. Scarred boobs, right side
crazy
really nice.
Like a fox.
Let's say hi to Jeff in North Carolina. Jeff, how are you?
Hey there, Jeff.
Morning, boys.
Hey, man.
Yeah, my wife had the surgery, too. And for this first couple years, I was like, what the hell did you do to your tits, kid? And
must have been lovely conversations around your house.
What did you do with your tits?
After about 5 years, the scarring really goes away. I mean, I can't even see it anymore.
Does it?
It's worth it. They look better now.
She went from B's to A's.
She wanted to be flat-chested.
Yeah.
How big were they originally there, Jeff?
She was a 36 double D, and she went down to a 36 C.
36 full C probably is that's perfect. I'm thinking.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, they're very nice.
All right, thank you, Jeff.
Yeah, have a good one.
Let's go to Josh. Josh,
what's up, guys?
Hey,
happy birthday, Jimmy.
Thank you.
No problem. My wife had it done. My sister had it done, and an ex-girlfriend of mine all had it done. I don't know about my
what
sister.
What the hell's going on with you?
Yeah. What's the what's the common denominator here? And why?
Yeah, I don't know. It sounds weird how a girl I dated and my wife had it done. But
yeah.
I'll tell you what, my wife's breasts look phenomenal now. She had one of the best
phenomenal.
Doctors in the Baltimore area, and I can't stop looking at them. They look so good. You would never know she had it done.
How many years ago?
Three.
See, maybe
she's only 20.
Maybe they figured it out.
Maybe they figured out the surgery, because the last time I saw a breast reduction scar in person, wow.
Well, she doesn't have that one that comes down from the nipple. It's right underneath the breast.
Right.
You would never know, but the doctor did have to remove the nipple to do all that kind of stuff. But it looks fantastic, and the best part is her doctor's name was Dean Cain. So, and he wore a stupid Superman thing on his head.
No, he didn't.
He did not.
Yes, he did.
Taking a little too far. What's going on with the nipple that they could just take it off, put it on the side?
Yeah, it is amazing.
It just hangs out on the side till they're done with the breast, and then they pop that thing back on.
Put on like a fucking pop bottle cap.
It's like a manhole cover.
But why isn't it effective after you take it off the body?
You lose sensitivity, I think, if it's not done right.
Yeah. I've heard that. Let's go to Psycho Bob in Baltimore. Psycho Bob.
Hey, good morning, boys. Good morning, boys.
Hey.
Good morning, boys.
Hey, there's a site that you may want to check. It's called awfulplasticsurgery.com, and you may find some interesting things there.
Yeah,
I'll let you know.
Let's take a look. I think we've checked out this site over the years, but I haven't been there in a while. Dan, what do we got on awfulplasticsurgery.com?
Yeah, I've seen this. They update this pretty regularly. I've seen some of the worst things on this website, like bad collagen implants and...
Oh,
just,
really?
Yeah, that Jocelyn Wildenstein is just always showing up on this website.
She's a beast. A real monster.
Yeah, you know her if you saw her. Mike in New York. What's up, Mike?
Mike!
Yo, what's up, guys?
Hey.
I want some advice and some help. Maybe I should go to this website. My wife has 44 triple Ds, and she's been talking about getting it done because it's killing her back and all that, but I'm telling her, you know, it's the surgery. I'm worried about it, you know, because I've heard the horror stories about it. So what do you think? I should tell her to go on that website and look for herself?
Well, wait, you want her to get the reduction or you don't want her?
Oh, hell no. I like them the way they are.
What's up with the phones? Well, you like the big boobies, huh?
Yes, sir. 44 triple D. That's nice.
Big monsters. Oh, God, that divot in. Ugh.
Yeah, Tori Spelling has the worst boob job ever.
There's a divot in there.
It's you're absolutely
right. It is. It's like someone teed up in her cleavage and took a big divot out.
Mm-hmm.
God damn. Why would she wear she should wear turtlenecks?
That shit's horrendous. Or a football jersey.
Yeah.
That horse face.
Oh, God.
All right, Mike. So you don't want her to get the breast reduction thing?
No, sir.
Okay. Jeff M. from Staten Island. Why not add a pros and cons photo section to SaveTheTidMonster.com?
Oh, God damn it.
Well, that's a tranny. What's her name? She's...
Amanda Lepore.
Yeah, she's in the news from time to time.
Oh.
Oof.
So, we're looking at, bad plastic surgery.
Horrible plastic surgery, yeah.
Is it called horrible?
Awful.
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 Awful plastic surgery.
Sorry for getting the name wrong. Awful.
Awful, horrible, bad. Speaking of boobies, we'll segue into another update on the coffee shop. Remember the topless coffee shop?
Of course. When last we left you, it had a tragic fire and burned down.
We've been following this place for years. Yeah, it burned down. It caused $500,000 in damage. And we were thinking Jewish lightning or something, but turns out the guy had no insurance.
No insurance.
So why would he do that?
Why?
Well, here's the update. They're relocating to a tent. This guy will not give up on topless coffee.
He knows
coffee.
People love the tits. They just want them.
The owner of a topless coffee shop destroyed by fire last week said he plans to have clothed waitresses collect donations in the parking lot to raise money to rebuild. Under town zoning rules, Donald Crabtree, would need a new permit to start operating his business from a trailer or other structure on the property. Instead, Crabtree set up a tent. So they're getting their coffee in a tent right now. And the, he has employees.
Oh, boy. Wild Bill's coffee with tits.
employees handing out free donuts and coffee next to a collection jar. He's never going to collect $500,000, though.
Not.
I mean, you know, guys love their tits, but
yeah,
not to the point where they're going to be able to raise that much money. So he's trying to stay in business. Now he's in a tent.
Giving it a whirl, huh?
Yeah.
Good luck to him. A tent. It's down to the point where there's a tent and some chicks with tits.
It's like, please, you know.
Who are the girls that, like, are going for this?
Can you imagine?
They've got to be a lower caliber than you'd get in, you know, tit bar.
They're probably not even day strippers.
No. Yeah, he's got a couple there. He's working it out. Manson style.
Yeah.
Got some followers.
Let's say hi to Dan in Virginia. Dan?
Dan.
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Pretty good, man.
All right, I got a great suggestion for the website. For the women that are trying to decide whether or not they want the surgery, send photos in, and then we vote on whether or not they should or shouldn't have the surgery. That takes care of two birds with one stone. We get pictures up there.
Two birds with one stone.
Mm, that lovely saying. Yeah.
It'd be good. People could vote on it, I guess.
Yeah, somehow we got to get a variety of pictures up there.
Yeah.
But save the titmonster.com. Check it out for yourself.
Up and running.
First day. I mean, it'll develop. Remember when fatyrock.com started? There was nothing going on the site. Now look at it.
And it turned into like Google.
Yes. What else is going on this morning? Oh, did you, what's up with the new iPhone? They finally announced what that's all about?
I gather they did.
Did you get one yet?
It's not
available. It comes out in a week or something, right?
Till the 19th, I believe.
10 days.
Yeah. I will be getting one. Little angry that the photo texting is not going to be available until the end of the summer. And that's all AT&T's fault.
That's
why they fucking stink, dude.
Because they said that there's a problem and they have to go through every account separately to do so. I don't even understand it.
They're pretty much the last phone to have video texting, right?
They're terrible.
Or picture texting.
I mean, picture MMS texting,
right?
Yeah. Picture texting. MMS, you're right.
It's a disgrace.
Isn't pretty much every phone you could do that, right?
Of course you can. It's a simple thing. And they're holding that back until the end of the summer.
AT&T is an embarrassment. Like they're not even an average carrier. They are an embarrassingly bad carrier.
Yeah. I have AT&T.
They're terrible.
I rarely have a problem.
Have you had Verizon?
I have but why would I get Verizon? I've never had a problem with AT&T.
I'm not going to mess with apartment? This.
Sort of.
I can't.
Sort of.
All right.
That's a rousing endorsement.
Can you make a call that doesn't get dropped? Or did you have to get a separate number? My Verizon.
I got a house phone because of that. But that's the only place my phone doesn't work.
It's Manhattan.
Apple.
It's Sixth Avenue. Drive down Sixth Avenue. When I'm driving from the cellar, if I go to the West Side Highway and I'm in the Village, there's a one area where it always gets dropped. Verizon never.
That's the only problem I have in my apartment. But I guess that would be a big problem, huh?
If you live there, sure.
If you have a cell phone, you can't. I always have to tell people, call me on the house phone.
Yeah, it's a thing. I think it's a terrible service.
Shoot video, then edit it right on your iPhone.
That's strong.
Make a call or play a song using voice control.
That's strong.
Search across your iPhone using Spotlight Search. That's on, your various contacts and stuff. Let Compass point you in the right direction. I guess one of the apps.
Well, Compass?
A Compass. Yeah, an app. I think I have a Compass app. On mine.
Why would you need a compass?
You wouldn't.
Because sometimes you need to know what direction you're going
in. Look up at the stars.
No, I have a GPS app.
Yeah, well.
Which, by the way, has a compass on it.
Mm-hmm.
On it. It's got a compass on it.
So, Ant, will you be able to? There's a feature on the iPhone called Notes. Take a little notebook you can type your thoughts onto, and they don't let you sync it up with your home computer. You can't download your notes. You should copy notes and then go home and then look at it and retype it on your computer.
They're just too controlling.
They're
just too controlling.
See, look, I got my latitude, my longitude,
right.
A little compass.
They're already making a shitload of money. Just put everything out on one phone. What are you doing? We missed the joke with the topless donut shop.
No, say it's not so.
Sean in North Carolina writes, does anyone find the irony that the owner of the topless coffee shop is pitching a tent?
Oh, see? All right, that's kind of funny.
So, are you happy or sad with the new iPhone?
Well, of course I'm happy. Introducing iPhone 3GS, fastest, most powerful iPhone yet.
But the picture
video recording,
thing.
Voice control, up to 32 gigs of storage, and more using 3GS. Quickly launches web pages, blah, blah, blah. Video. Now you can shoot, edit it, and share it all on your iPhone 3GS. Shoot high-quality VGA video in portrait or landscape. Trim your footage by adjusting start and end points. Then share your video in an email. Post it to your mobile Me gallery, of course. Jimmy loves Mobile Me.
It's horrendous. Mobile Me.
What's wrong with Mobile Me?
What's wrong with Mobile Me? Nothing if you like just losing information. It's so bad. I had it. Sometimes all my contacts would just disappear from my phone.
Why did everyone buy the iPhone if it wasn't ready to go?
Because we're dummies.
No, it was good enough. Good enough to go.
But the...
The pluses outweighed the minuses, and I still think they do.
You know what, though? I don't know how I would live without picture texting. And you still don't picture text.
Picture texting, very important. So I picture email. I have to get emails. I tell people, email me the goddamn picture.
Right.
And I could check the email on my phone, and I get the picture.
You get around it.
You know what drives me nuts, though? It's that the positives outweigh the negatives, but the negatives are unnecessary.
Yeah, you're right.
And they're only there because, A, Apple was being greedy, or, B, AT&T was just not a good carrier.
Yeah. Mm.
They didn't need to be there. Can you, by the way, like you can do with a BlackBerry, can you text video?
I have no idea.
With the new amazing iPhone, you can text video?
Text. It says, share your video in an email. Doesn't say text.
Yeah.
Post it to your mobile media gallery, publish it on YouTube, or sync it back to your Mac or PC using iTunes.
That's solid.
Learn more about video recording.
No, that's solid. I got that on the BlackBerry. That's
a good one.
That's solid. Where you just take a little video and then you could email it.
Shoot in widescreen.
Widescreen,
on the go.
Really?
Share it with anybody. Tap the camera icon in Messages to record on the fly and send it to your buddy via MMS. So you will be able to send video on MMS.
Hmm.
But not picture text?
Well, I'm sure the pictures and video will be at the end of the summer.
What the fuck are they doing?
I don't know.
Just put it all out. At the end of the summer, if you want that, is it a free download?
Yeah, I'm sure it'll just be a little upgrade thing that you got to do.
All right.
There does seem to be a lot of stuff. Copy-paste, which has been a big issue.
Copy-paste? What are you talking about?
We haven't been able to copy-paste from emails and whatnot.
What?
Yes, very annoying.
Why are they holding back the basic stuff?
I don't know.
Let's go to Steve. Steve.
Yes.
Is this the O&A show, or is this Consumers Reports for the iPhone?
Consumers Reports?
Yeah.
Well, I don't know. This announcement yesterday was kind of big.
And all of us, not all of us, but a lot of us have the iPhone. We talk about it. Is there a problem?
He already hung up.
Of course he did. You were a horrible caller. Horrible fucking caller. With a complete lack of understanding of what this show is about.
If Apple announces a new iPhone, we want to talk about it a little bit.
Yeah.
And I have no intention of getting an iPhone, but I still have an interest in it for some reason. Because it seems like everybody in the world has one.
Yeah.
Wherever you go.
People are plinking away on that thing. Plink, plink, plink. Voice control. That sounds like an interesting little concept.
What's voice control?
I don't know. Making a call on an iPhone has always been easy. With voice control, it's even easier. Now you can make calls and play music using just the sound of your own voice. So I guess you just say,
okay.
Hey, play this or call this person.
And with that crack, with that crack audio quality, I'm sure it'll work every time. Yes, but I'm sure it will.
But you've drank the Kool-Aid, Jimmy. I see you got an iPhone
because
right
the
in front
iPhone,
of you.
The iPhone
seems like you hate it
with a vengeance. But what bothers me is I know I'm going to get rid of it, and then it's finally going to be. What bothers me is what it could be. Could be such an amazing thing. And they even Louis C.K. and Louis's a Mac guy. Like Louis loves everything Mac. He just stopped paying his iPhone bill and went back to his BlackBerry. It was such a piece of shit. It's great for certain things and the idea of having it. But the fact that when you send someone a picture, you have to go to a website called viewmymessage.com.
That whole thing is ridiculous.
That's amazing.
But it's fucking. It's almost like it's almost thievery. It's bad. It never works.
Mm-hmm. It is crazy.
View my. If someone sends you a picture, you have to go to viewmymessage.com.
Who would
you
do that?
An incompetent,
there's
terrible
no need
carrier.
For it.
Half the time, when someone just sends you like a. Something in a text, you don't even open it up.
How about this now? You get me? Yeah.
Because you're like, all right. Like, well, I know if E-Rock sends me something, there's no reason to click on the picture.
No, it's some worthless.
For real.
Yeah, I hear you.
For real. And he means well, but there are people in your life, when they send you something, you just know there's no reason to click on this. I will save the 20 seconds.
What do you think he sends you? Like, just worthless, unfunny little things he sees in the line?
It's just, I can't even really explain what he sends. Like, it's stuff he finds interesting.
Oh,
he's
good.
Out and about, and he takes a picture.
Nothing.
Look what I
food.
Saw. Look what I saw today. And then you open it up, and it's like a traffic cop or something.
Yeah.
Like,
oh, good.
What's the point? What are you trying to tell me here?
Or it'll say Greg's Hardware Store because it's got the same name as you.
Right,
like,
right.
Oh, that's cool.
Exactly. What
the fuck am I going to do with that?
Exactly. Something like that.
Now, also.
Or screen caps like the fact that he's playing Punch Out. Like, well, I don't.
Yeah, who cares?
Because look what I defeated today. And then you click on it. It's like, it's a screen cap of Punch Out.
And then he says, look what I lost to, and it's obesity.
Sorry, Eric. You were saying it.
Keyboard now, when you're texting and stuff, it was, you know, you had to hold it straight up and use it like that. Now you will be able to type
sideways
in landscape mode.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
And use a much bigger keyboard on that thing. So that's a plus. That's something people were clamoring about.
Anthony, all those are pluses, but the picture texting, though.
You're going to have to wait until the end of the summer.
But
I understand.
That's just something they should have figured out way before all this other stuff.
Yeah, well.
Before you could, you know.
They did.
Text message using landscape.
The
they
iPhone
should have figured it all out.
No, the iPhone did. It's AT&T. That's got the problem.
But
AT&T's got the fucking big problem with this shit.
Huh.
I know. Pain in the ass.
Runtime error. Something's going on with the phone. I just lost the phones.
What?
We've had...
Oh, the phones have... Why they look different or not?
Because someone used our studio last night, and every time someone uses our studio... And I'm not going to name names.
Yeah.
The place is a mess.
Yeah.
I just lost the phones, Mars. Is it true every time someone uses a studio, there's problems the next day?
Yeah.
Seems to be, right? I lost the phones. Let's take a break because the phones were lit and it's important. And we'll continue. Opie and Anthony, stay there. Yeah, that's right. Let's go. Dun, dun, dun. Dun, dun, dun. Dun, dun, dun. Dun, dun, dun. It's the Opie and Anthony Show.
I'm trying to figure out what happened. I have a spare battery for my MacBook Pro, and I carry it in my laptop carry-on bag, which I bring on the plane with me. So I opened it last night to put it in my computer, and it's exploded. Like, it's fucking, it's burst out. It looks like a popcorn thing that has burst out, and I don't know what's. I'm going to Twitter it.
That looks like heat damage.
But from where? I have the...
From in itself. Like, the battery itself probably shorted out, heated up, and just warped the metal. Lucky it didn't start a fire.
Jesus. Because these Mac laptops,
but
I think...
it look like... Let me see.
Smell it. You would smell a little fire damage or a little, like...
You might.
It does not smell like that at all.
There should be discoloration or something if...
Yeah, what is... Exactly what happened? What's
so
that?
Warped, though.
Yeah, why don't you open it up? See what's inside.
No, I'm going to bring it to Mac like that.
Bring it like that.
Yeah, what does that mean?
I bet you there's a cockroach living inside.
Oh, my God. That is a picture of your fucking battery, dude. Well,
apparently, that's not the first one that's happened to. So.
What happens to them?
Well, they expand, and it looks like they kind of explode.
But how do they... Why did they expand? They give a reason?
Not on this particular website.
But but you sent a picture of Jimmy's battery.
This is... Oh, I see. The little cells in here kind of expanded. and pushed it out. Wow.
Are human cells?
Dude, that is...
Are they making...
That is an exact picture of this clusterfuck battery. Look at
what
that.
What the fuck, man?
Are they... Seems to be a problem other people have
So
had.
Should I not leave this in my bag? What's causing this?
Oh.
I don't burn my apartment down with a battery.
It doesn't seem to be the heat, but it...
It's probably all the kiddie porn trying to get out.
No, that stuff I put on disc.
Not on the battery.
I know it as well. Yeah, I just...
Oh, kitty. I spell it K-I-T-T-Y.
Yes.
I like to fuck cats. Meow. Meow. No, I don't know what it is, man. It's driving me nuts. Though.
So,
any answers?
Not yet. I'll get to the bottom.
Yeah, Danny will get an answer.
Wow.
I got to bring The Hangover to the show's attention because now I'm confused. I went and saw The Hangover yesterday.
Yeah.
I liked it. It wasn't an over the top, holy shit, there's a million just incredible laughs in the movie, but it's a well written comedy. Then I tweeted just that for the most part.
If you're not laughing in the first 20 minutes, should you leave?
I was definitely laughing throughout the whole movie. And then I tweeted that. And then people said I didn't give it a good enough review. They're like, what? That was like one of the funniest movies ever. But then other people said it was garbage and it was horrible. And then I get in today and Jimmy said they were discussing The Hangover at the Cellar last night. And Keith Robinson killed it, right?
He said he didn't like it, yeah. But I Colin and Nick, I don't think had seen it. But he said he didn't like it.
Was he the only one that didn't see it?
I don't know.
I mean, the only one that saw it, I'm sorry.
I believe he was, yeah.
I liked the movie. So now I don't know what to... I wonder what the listeners are thinking. And then Mall Cop was brought up. Now, how much did Mall Cop make?
Well over 100 million.
I finally sat down and watched Mall Cop. I watched the first half hour to 40 minutes. And then I just... got up off the couch. There were a bunch of people over.
Threw yourself out a window.
Actually, I didn't have to get up because everyone has remotes now. But I picked up the remote and just pushed stop. And everyone said, thank you.
You weren't laughing just at him on the Segway?
Not only was I not laughing at Mall Cop the first 40 minutes, I didn't even know where I was supposed to laugh if I was a comedy dummy. You know what I mean?
Comedy dummies, yeah, that laugh like, at dumb movies.
Like, I wish I was in the theater, because then I would have went, oh, I'm supposed to laugh. I didn't even know where I was supposed to laugh.
Yeah, no gauge.
No clue. Yeah. Like, was I supposed to laugh when he was on the Segway?
Oh,
I don't know.
Because it's hysterical. He's a big guy, and he's on a Segway.
Doing weird Segway things as a fat guy in a Segway.
Yeah,
but
hysterical.
I know what Keith was complaining about with the movie.
Okay.
He said that they were using props. And instead, some of the writing he didn't like. He's like, I could see what the writers were doing. It was so obvious. Like, he just didn't like how obvious some of the things were. And again, I don't know what he's talking about because I haven't seen it.
I thought, as far as comedies go, it was well written.
Jesus, that movie.
It might have been. Keeps the race.
Mall Cop made $147
million. Oh, God.
And let's discuss
$47 million.
The Hangover for a couple minutes and Mall Cop. Like, tell me where I was supposed to laugh in Mall Cop. I really want to know. Knowing, by the way, that I only saw the first half hour to 40 minutes.
Yeah.
I would have seen it. Yeah.
It was a long setup to the first laugh that I never got to.
First laugh.
And then I just threw in Network, and everyone was very happy to check out Network.
Oh, how great is it?
The movie's amazing.
What a brilliant insight he had into what television was going to be.
Yeah. Yeah, you got to remember, like, there was only a few TV channels when they
saw reality TV coming. They saw all of it, man. Patty Chastain.
Reality? Oh, jeez. There go the phones. They just disappeared. Phones just disappeared.
Why does this company insist on sharing our studio if it can't be set up properly for our show, the main show? We just lost like 10 or 12 really good fucking phones.
Yeah.
Someone was in studio yesterday. I'm not even blaming that person. I don't want to name names, but somebody that was associated with yesterday's show that was in this studio fucked up something because we can't get phones today. They just disappeared again, Morris.
Yeah, they just vanished.
And this company insists on sharing the studio, which is fine if we don't ever notice.
Yeah, if we never know.
If we never knew someone was in here, I don't give a shit if they have an orgy in front of, on this big table in front of us. I could care less as long as they clean up and we don't have a clue.
But it's just, I don't know why so many things have to be touched. We broadcast.
I don't
Everything seems fine.
We barely touch anything.
Everything seems fine. We take calls. We talk into the microphones. What are people doing? Are they setting things so they could talk to Venus? What's the difference between us broadcasting and someone coming in here and broadcasting.
And we just set up a nice phone topic, so...
Oh, I know. Yeah, yeah.
Let's go to the phones. The phones were nice and lit with comments about those two movies. Some liked it, some didn't like it. We were going to try to discuss it a little bit, and then poof, there go the phones.
Look at this connect, and then does it even connect? A connection to the server could not be made. It's just a catastrophe.
Out of all... There are... How many studios are here? Why do they have to use this one?
You think our fucking... Yeah, you think everybody else's phones just... go out like this?
You know, during breaks, I walk down the long hall to the bathroom. There are so many studios that are just not being used here.
Yeah.
And I would imagine it's the same thing at night. So have them use another one.
More so at night, I would say. Now, why can't they just use a different studio? Just don't use this fucking studio. This should be for us and Imran and Fez. Because it doesn't seem like they destroy the fucking thing. But it's this late night shit. People come in, and then there's always an excuse or something. I don't know.
Are they going to work now? You don't know, right?
Connect.
They're going to work
until they don't work. Yeah. At least Mars is honest.
Can't win for losing.
Let's make a pact. If the phones crap out again, we go home.
Oh, Jesus.
And even if they don't.
We need proper equipment.
Even if they don't.
I have a very short throat.
We need proper equipment to do our show.
Yeah.
We need a
That was a dial tone. Probably a good sign.
Did you see Mall Cop?
Me?
Mm-hmm.
Fuck no. And my pal is in it.
I know. Adam Ferrar is in it. I didn't get to Adam Ferrar.
Yeah, didn't get to his scene?
I wanted to. Because I think I would have turned off Mall Cop in the first 10 minutes. Because I realized, wow, there's nothing here for me.
Uh-huh.
And then I'm like, wait, Adam's in this, though. Maybe I'll try to get to Adam's part.
Yeah.
Just to tell him, you know, I saw Mall Cop next time he comes in here. I never got to Adam's part.
You know, I'm sure he's, you know, he's done some projects where he's just like, cash the check. Oh,
but it's amazing that, like, as a performer.
I'll
say comedian, because Kevin James is actually a good comic and whatever. It's like, you do a movie like that. He had a hit show, though, so it's hard to say, but it's like, you do a movie that makes $140 million, you're made.
Exactly.
I mean, that's it.
Yeah.
You're doing a couple of more fucking multi-million dollar films, you're set for life.
Yeah, you made a successful movie. Doesn't matter if people thought it was shit.
But what's confusing, we talked to some of these guys that have been in movies that are definitely shit.
Shit.
But made a lot of money.
Yep.
And you kind of call them out on the fact that the movie sucked. And they go, what? It made $100 million. That has happened a few times on our show.
Seth Rogen got married.
It happened with Seth Rogen.
And what's his name?
There's at least another person... not Seth Rogen.
No, Seth Green.
Seth Green.
I brought up that river movie, Up the River, or whatever the fuck it was called.
Because we were having fun with the guy, and he's obviously had a very successful career.
Yeah.
He's in some amazing things. So we're like, oh, but that Up the Creek thing.
I go, yeah, but you did that friggin' river movie. He goes, that river movie made 100 and something... Like, I take a joke. I'm not fucking...
But that's the question. You think in their world that means it was a success? Yeah. Or do you think someone like Kevin James goes, I know it made $147 million, but I'm not proud of that film.
You know who
I bet both.
You really think both?
Sure.
You know who knows? A guy like Michael Madsen. Mm. That's an honest gentleman.
Yep.
He knows when he's making a big tub of shit because he'll fucking admit it right on his website. Go, here, I use this one to make a car payment. I use this movie to pay the mortgage.
Dennis Leary did that recently.
Oh, did he? Interesting.
Dennis Leary decided to do that.
Snappy, you don't like your sandwich?
It's all right.
Making a face.
You don't like your cream cheese bagel?
Okay.
That's all right?
It's all right.
You must like it because there's cream cheese on your upper lip. You're enjoying it.
Clockwork Orange. What's jobbing how much? The most obnoxious chewing in a film.
Oh, yeah. Ever.
Is what?
Bar none, I
clockwork.
Say.
Clockwork, yeah. Absolutely. which is worse, Mall Cop or Chuck and Larry? Did you see Chuck and Larry?
I wouldn't fucking turn that on if my family was in danger. And the only way to get them out of danger was to watch that.
Who are they making these comedies for?
Comedy.
Who are they making it for? Are people out there that dumb? I don't think our audience is that dumb. There'll probably be a few that will now call and defend Chuck and Larry. But in general, our audience would say, no fucking way. No way, no how.
They have to get married. They're two men. It would be funny if, like, they had to go through with everything and fuck each other.
Mm.
There it is, just big fucking sloppy party bottom.
You know, if you're going to make a bad movie that makes over $100 million, it should be in your contract that you got to take it in the ass on film.
Chuck and Larry made $120 million.
Fuck.
I don't get it.
Kevin James has done two comedy films. I know Sandler's in one, which is massive. But he's been, like, one of the leads in two movies. $267 million fucking dollars, that guy. I think
it wasn't a movie where you needed, like, a CGI or anything like that, so it wasn't one of these high production movies.
Just the actors' salaries and whatever. Yeah. I think that what a lot of these films appeal to, and one of the reasons they do so well...
Mongoloids?
the Pete Rose haircuts are endless. But no, I think it's because a lot of people... I happen to like mean comedy. That makes me laugh.
Yep.
Or what people think is mean. But I think a lot of people want their comedy to not be mean. And it seems like a lot of the films that do tremendously well don't have an element of real meanness in them. They're just kind of silly, and they are kind of like, oh, come on now. And I think people like that a little bit more than the mean stuff.
Yeah.
My gauge is off.
You like to observe and report.
I never laugh in movies. When Ray Liotta screamed at him, I hate your fucking guts! I think that's what I fucking screamed in the theater. Well, when they were bashing, when Seth Rogen and the other guy are taking skateboards and breaking them across those teenagers' faces and heads, it was violent hilarious.
Because it's violent. It's something you're out of the ordinary.
I really laughed at that. Seth Rogen was, oh, come on, he's fucking Anna Faris. She's passed out and she's got vomit on her and he's fucking her. And the film, they had to make it look like
hilarious in that film.
It wasn't a rape?
It wasn't a rape, no. So she's like, come on. So
come
she did
on
talk.
Already, let's just so go.
Which I was like, all right, I guess they had to do that because it was a rape. But it was like she had puke on her and he's fucking her. And I'm like, that's what a comedy should be. That's it right there.
That's reality.
But it was a movie about a serial killer. And they were showing him having sex with a passed out girl. They would show it like that to portray it like that. But because it's a fucking comedy, you have to soften it? I never understood that.
Yeah, yeah.
No.
Why does comedy have to be softened, but drama doesn't?
I know.
That's a very good question. Hey, a lot of people say Mall Cop was definitely funnier than Chuck and Larry, or Larry and Chuck, or whatever the fuck. What was it called again? For real.
Chuck and Larry.
Chuck and Larry. Mike in Boston.
What's up, boys?
Hey.
Paul Blart wasn't too bad. I mean... Oh, no, wait a minute. That movie fucking sucks. I just saw it. That fucking was awful. Both those movies could lick my friggin' balls. Holy shit.
Wow, lick his balls.
Yeah, I hated them. They were friggin' awful. I watched that whole Mall Cop movie, and what the hell was with, like, skateboarders and bikers doing jumps into the friggin' scenes? I mean, honestly, you're robbing a mall, and you have, like, bikers doing jumps?
See,
what the fuck?
I never got to that point. He lost me in the first half hour. I just couldn't sit through it anymore. He pulled over an old guy that was on a scooter or something. I'm like, what?
That's hysterical. Was he on a Segway when he did it?
Yeah, he was on a Segway.
See, that's funny. And the old guy's on a little, like, a little rascal scooter.
And he's yelling at the guy, pull over.
Come on, dude. Come on, that's hysterical stuff.
I don't even know why he pulled the guy over in the mall. I'm like, what?
Why would he do that?
You know what made me laugh? Used cars made me laugh.
Yeah, I gotta watch Used Cars.
Mean spirited,
big black Frank McRae when he's trying to sell the car to the old guy. He's fucking. There's nothing funny.
Look at his face. He's on the Segway. He's got a little blue light on it too, which I'm sure at some point in the movie it goes on, and it's like, look, he's got a little rotating beacon on it. He doesn't need that.
Oh, let's say hi to Tony in New York, Tony.
You know, to Jimmy's point, Adam Sandler, when he made Billy Madison and Happy Gilmore, those were funny movies and they were raw. And then he came out with The Wedding Singer and it was, safe, funny comedy. He was okay, but it wasn't great comedy.
Yeah, I thought The Wedding Singer was all right.
I love The Wedding Singer.
But I think you make a good point. The Wedding Singer is where he started changing.
Yeah, yeah, into the sensitive...
I was excited to watch that movie, what was it called, Click? Where he had a remote control that could control the world in front of him.
Yeah.
I thought the concept was good, and then all of a sudden it went into this deep, fucking weird place. I'm like, what are you doing, trying to, like, give us a message? Just give us some laughs.
That's exactly what he did. tried to a message tried to.
Is there
come
anything
out of
worse
it?
Than comedies that try to give you a message?
Ow.
The message is always predictable. That's what's annoying.
Yeah, yeah.
It's never like an interesting point. It's always the same. Oh, we get it. You're
in
a
your
comic.
Face.
You hate this, or you're. We get it. It's always the same. I've never seen the Adam Sandler film, so I don't know. Never.
Not one.
Not on purpose. I just haven't seen one.
Happy Gilmore was fun.
Yeah, I never saw it.
Yeah, that was
a pretty
was
good
fun.
Movie.
That was your typical underdog against the snobby guy kind of thing.
The one with the little kid. What was that called again, Ant?
Big Daddy.
Big Daddy, I liked.
Big Daddy. You liked Big Daddy?
Yeah, that was kind of safe, but...
What about...
Oh, my God. I never saw that movie.
You never saw it?
I just know the character like anyone else.
Little Nicky.
Was Little Nicky good? Did you see it?
Was Little Nicky... It was so weird.
You don't know?
He's the son of fucking Satan.
Hey, for the boys down the hall, I heard about this. Kevin from Connecticut... John Sterling had a horrendous home run call yesterday.
Oh, what else?
Nick Swisher hit a home run, so you can only imagine what he came up with.
Oh, Swish no. goes the ball!
Swisher?
I don't know.
I can't even say his name. Yeah, or Swisher? 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 Huh?
Swisher.
Swisher? That's how you pronounce it? All right. Wait till you hear the home run call.
Do we have it?
We're going to get it.
Is it a Swisher? Wisher? It probably rhymed.
Waterboy, you like Waterboy?
Douchebag.
No.
Waterboy had its moments. Let's say hi to Marcos in New York. Marcos.
Hey, what's up, boys?
Hey.
Hey, I was going to say Waterboy was a pretty funny movie. You guys didn't like that one?
I saw it so many years ago. I would have to see it again. I remember there were a couple good scenes in it. I don't know.
He was just... He was too...
The way he was tackling people, it was pretty funny.
He's too fucking weird in it and... Like that over-the-top shit is just too weird.
His mom wouldn't let him get laid.
My mama says I gotta...
That stupid fucking voice again, all right?
All right, boys.
Had it with him.
Not a fan of Adam Sandler?
Not at all anymore.
Let's say hi to Keith. Keith.
Yeah.
Well, this isn't the break we were trying to do. We really want to talk about why Mall Cop was considered funny. And if anyone saw The Hangover, and what's your opinion on the movie? Is it good or bad? I liked it.
Yeah.
But some people say, no, it sucked. It was horrible. So I want to gauge that movie today a little bit, too.
Somehow we went off to Adam Sandler sucks now.
Yeah, no kidding. All right, go ahead, Keith. We got you on the line. What's up?
Yeah, listen, man. The Adam Sandler movies are just terrible. Come on. What about, like, real comedies? Easy Money, Animal House? Those are the funny movies. That's what we should be gauging new movies on.
You know what? They're trying to go back to those type of comedies. They really are.
Yeah.
With the whole Seth Rogen gang and stuff, they're really trying to go back to that Animal House type of comedy. We're getting there, I think. I feel good where these comedies going lately.
You know what movie?
They don't seem to be as cookie cutter anymore.
I saw a movie recently that was just, I sat through it, but it wasn't funny at all. Porky's.
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 Doesn't hold up.
Is not funny. I don't even know about holding up. It just isn't funny. I'm watching it going, there isn't a laugh in this thing at all. It's like, you know, you watch it because, okay, here they go. They go over to Porky's, and then Porky fucks them over, and then they wreck Porky's place. The
mm-hmm.
end.
Mm-hmm.
That fucking Pee-wee character that is trying to get laid is so over-the-top. Stupid.
Why? Why so bad? I don't remember. What's so bad?
Yeah, I'm going to have to watch Porky's
again.
Oh,
he's just too, like, everything's about getting laid, and he's too over the top about it, and I don't know. And the girls in it are supposed to be hot.
They're not.
Wow. And when they're looking through that little peephole into the
they're
shower.
They're huge muffs, right?
Huge, huge fucking muffs. Dude, those muffs were giant. Giant muffs.
Just want to talk to the youth of America. We took one for the team for you guys.
Oh, Christ.
We used to have to dig into that shit.
Did we ever? There's the shout. Look.
Oh, my God.
Look at the muffs.
If you saw that today, wouldn't that just scare the fuck out of you?
No, like I said, I wouldn't mind a little the hair these days. Just,
really?
Just to see. You know why?
Oh,
just
get
to
out of mix my house. It up.
You know why?
Get out.
Everyone fucking shaves it down these days. How about you change it up a little bit? Look at the muff on
her. looks like she's wearing black panties.
It's ridiculous. The one in the back right there. That's like
Those were supposed to be hot girls.
But that's like...
They're all right, but the one in the middle's all right.
I gotta fucking just... Every pussy now is shaved completely raw. And I don't know.
What do we need? A little something going on there?
Let's just get a little something growing there. Can we just get a little something there to remember? No, just to remember what that looked like.
Memories?
Yes, nostalgia.
Cue up memories.
I just want a little nostalgia when it comes to some fucking muff. That's why they called it muff, bush, pussy. That's what the fucking name came from, by gum.
Yeah, but a lot of pussies out there that are hairless cats.
Not many. That, oh, Jesus, look at that broad. Look at
through,
her.
Through the little hole.
I think she was one of the, like, stars of the movie. Look at that. See, that it was just that triangle of hair that was so, like, made you go like, oh, look, because it's hair, but there's no dick there.
and you wonder if they shampoo it or use soap.
Yeah.
Which one?
Just one of those things that you kind of like.
I want to give props to that last caller. We lost him a few minutes ago, but he mentioned Easy Money as a good comedy. And
yeah.
Bravo to you, my friend.
Yeah, that was a good one.
How many people saw Easy Money, you think? That doesn't come up in comedy discussions.
No.
Let's say hi to Pete in New York. Pete.
Hey, what's up, boys?
Hey, Pete.
Hey, I saw The Hangover this weekend. I thought it was probably one of the funniest movies I've ever
seen.
Don't
touch it. Just bury it.
You think just bury it?
Just drag it down where it's not in the way.
You sure?
Yeah.
Let's just leave it.
Just put it in the corner.
Mars, we might lose the phones. I'm moving this thing like it's plutonium.
You're moving it like it's a bomb. Something just came up, a runtime error, invalid property value, and do not hit okay. Just look at this streak it made across the phone.
Yeah. Oh, look at it. Just erased everything.
Hit okay, you're fine.
Oh, you want me to hit okay?
No, the phones will die. No. Yeah, they will.
Just because I wasn't able to email him. Steve Blatter, this is causing major problems on our show today once again.
See if you can take another call without it blowing up. Don't touch that. Where's the mouse? Oh, you can't do anything until you...
You have to hit okay. It's the only way to do it.
Or just shut it down. Oh, Jesus. Wait.
You didn't lose the caller.
We didn't lose the no. The caller or all of the callers?
No, none of the callers are lost.
None of them are lost?
Hello?
Yeah.
Hold on, sir.
We can't hang up on you, so say whatever the fuck you want.
Yeah, it's your show now.
It's your show now. For real, go ahead.
You're the boss.
Go ahead, go. This is a rare opportunity. You can say whatever the fuck you want. We can't do shit.
That's right.
All right, let's talk about The Hangover.
I like The Hangover.
You like
what do you think? Hang on. What did you think of the last 1 minute? Of all those pictures.
What are you saying the end of the show for, the movie, sir?
Let's just say, yeah, I mean, we're trying not to be dicks like we used to be with movies. Let's just say the last few minutes of the movie was just amazing.
It was good?
Oh, it just, there was an excitement in the theater when they did what they did at the end.
Really?
Yeah, it was like, it brought it all together nicely.
I am?
Yeah, I agree. I thought it was hysterical. Not trying to give anything away. Sorry.
It's okay. Did you see Mall Cop?
I saw Mall Cop, and I did the same thing you did. 20 minutes, half an hour, shut it right off. I thought it was awful.
It really was bad. I mean, we know Kevin's a nice guy and all that, very successful, and he doesn't need our endorsement. He does very well for himself, but I think I would be embarrassed if I was him, for real.
Really? That bad? Yeah.
I didn't understand where... You got to, like... If I at least knew that I was supposed to laugh somewhere, I go, okay, someone out there is laughing because this is where you're supposed to laugh.
Right.
They should have had like that like laugh like light go on or
a
something.
A little light.
That would help.
All right, boys, punching out.
I'm just looking up at the Morning Joe show, Joe Scarborough's book, The Last Best Hope, and the picture is him on the cover, like with his arms folded. That looks fucking horrendous. Ugh.
These two fruits.
How big is fucking Joe Scarborough? Was he 6'8"?
Oh, Jesus. Oh, my God, no.
I'm just...
Oh, my God, hold on.
Are people mad at me because I said that?
Just breathe. No, the runtime error thing came up again. Mars fixed
it. And this
is
because someone used our studio again last night.
Yeah.
The company insists that people use our studio, even though they told us they were going to give us our own studio.
Yeah.
And all we ask is that the studio is put back the way it was so we could not be distracted and taken completely out of our game.
Yeah.
We have been taken completely out of our game.
We're trying so hard to hang on here by our fingernails and not lose our minds and smash shit. But it's getting very difficult to do that. Like, I wanted to talk to Lydia.
We're completely out of our game.
I want to talk to the guy about John Hughes comedies, because he says it ruined a comedy. I disagree.
That would be a great phone call.
And I would like to know why he says that. Yeah.
Bad Santa is the best movie. I loved Bad Santa. That's the type of movie you would like. You ever seen it, Jimmy?
I did enjoy that, yeah.
Yeah, because it's mean-spirited.
You know,
yeah.
Billy Bob annoys me so fucking much. How can I have liked the guy so much and just hate his guts now?
I know. Like, in Sling Blade, he was fantastic.
He was fantastic. You hated him in Bad Santa?
No, he was funny in that. I don't know what. I think after they soften the Bad News Bears and he's supposed to be an edgy guy.
Dude.
Astronaut Farmer, he was really good in.
Don't get me started with that.
Bad News. It sucked.
Well, Bad News Bears, that remake was an embarrassment to comedy. Yeah. How do you fuck with Bad News Bears and make it kind of like kid and family friendly?
Wasn't there no drunk driving in, like no beer in the car or something?
Yeah, instead of drinking beer, they were drinking, I don't even remember.
You can't show
something?
The kids drinking because that's a bad message.
Unbelievable.
Yeah.
Lydia, I think we still have you.
Hey, guys. Good
Hi.
Morning.
Hi, Lydia.
So I wanted to know, Anthony, if you are so jaded that bald pussy doesn't even turn you on.
Hey, Miss Shrink, did I ever say it didn't turn me on? All I'm saying is a little variety. Every girl thinks that they just got to shave that fucking thing down a bare skin every fucking day or else it's not going to be attractive to anybody. I would like to see some hair down there at some point. Just even if I want to look and just go, okay, that's what it looks like. I forgot what a fucking pussy with hair on it looks like.
Do we need to start a new website?
No, we do not.
SaveTheHair.com for Anthony.
Hair.
SaveTheHair.com.
No, you know why? Because they get these fetish ones like that. See, the look, look. See, that's a little too much.
I don't like, I don't like weeds around the...
Yeah.
I don't mind a little hair above, but then when it's like... It's on the border of the
See,
around the
you're
lips.
You're going right. One extreme to the other, and I'm not. Uh oh. Better watch out.
What?
The curtains weren't closed. I'm saying we. You're going one extreme to the other. Either shaved or fucking Wolfman. And I'm not talking the little landing strip or the Hitler mustache that looks ridiculous. I'm talking natural shape triangle. But well kept, you know, just kind of trimmed.
No.
And just looking
wide,
like a
wide
pussy.
Triangle?
No.
Just kind of the shape.
Used to be popular.
What's that?
That's what used to be popular.
Are you shaved, Lydia?
I'm shaved.
How much do you shave?
I shave it all.
Oh,
see,
sexy.
See, some women shouldn't
shave it all.
I think after a certain age, some women should stop shaving that fucking thing, shaving it all.
No.
I was thinking about that, Anthony.
Stop
I think
it. Bullshit. Here's what hair is. It's a leftover from evolution. We don't need it to keep warm. All it does is make it stink. I like to see the lips. There's no reason for a bunch of tangled, ugly hair. It gets sweaty and matted down. It looks like a forehead. It's terrible.
Forehead.
Fucking terrible. You ever see a lawyer's forehead? That's what a
During
pussy
a tough case.
Yeah, exactly. The little hair's all matted. It's fucking horrendous.
I'm not talking about that. And I'm not talking about these bushes that Danny's putting up on the screen. Danny must be... What did you put in the search?
Oh, my God.
Big, fat, hairy pussies.
That looks like a head wound, for
that
real.
That does look like Kennedy.
That looks
that
like a
looks
Kennedy
like
photo.
Kennedy's autopsy
yeah,
photo.
Yeah, sure.
Oh, God, why?
That's... No,
that's
see...
That's disgusting.
I'm not talking about that.
That's fucking horrendous, man.
I'm talking about a nicely trimmed... Everything's nicey nice. All in order, well taken care of, but there's something down there. There was just something about the underwear coming off, the little panties coming off, and seeing that little tuft.
Perfect,
right there. See, look, there's
perfect.
A little bit on there. It lets you know it's there.
You got the chimp lips.
The chimp lips.
Looking real nice. And you got a little something going on above
Homer Simpson mouth.
How about sideways this? Homer Simpson mouth. Nice.
You look in the panties and you see a big fat bulge and it's all lips. And then you pull it off and it's bald and that whole big bulge you were looking at was all lips. And here's what's worse. When you think there's a big sexy pair of lips and you pull it off and you realize it was the fucking hair puffing out the panties.
See, I wouldn't be into that at all. That's I wouldn't be into the big hairy.
That's the Jiffy
like
Pop
that.
Popcorn.
The big hairy.
Yeah. Making Jiffy Pop popcorn in her underwear.
Sort of figuring out how.
All right, Lydia, please shut the fuck up. Really.
Just don't.
Can't Lydia just be fun sometimes? I think what's going on, Lydia, can't you just.
I think it's.
What these women are thinking is there's a. No, it's weird. I actually like Lydia. She's sexy for her age, but it's the voice.
Yeah.
It goes right through you.
Really does.
I'm so sorry about that.
Can you do something about your voice, and then maybe I won't tell you to shut the fuck up so much?
Yeah, well, I don't mind so much, okay.
Why don't you do some of that morning drinking?
Patty thing.
How's the drinking going?
Oh, drinking is going just fine. I think Gary put me back on the wagon again.
Oh, really?
They had an episode.
What was the episode?
Oh, boy.
A long weekend, you know.
Lost weekend.
She woke up with a man of questionable ethnicity in a motel.
Long weekend. See, she doesn't long feel like weekend. Holding your hair for 8 hours every weekend.
Holding her hair. Yeah. All right. You okay?
Oh shit! Can I go back to the game?
Suburban barbecues.
Hair's in the toilet.
Yeah. All right, Lydia. We got to go. And unfortunately, we got 10 phone calls on hold with great stuff. But as I do this, watch the phones go.
That'll be fine.
Poof.
Oh, they're gone.
Just lost the phones again because the company insists on sharing our studio.
Mars.
And now you get a show today that is very distracted.
That's half-assed, as I like to call it.
How does that make sense?
It's a half-assed show.
I don't know how that makes sense, but for some reason it makes sense to the company.
We're not very liked.
They continue to do this to us.
No.
We're broken records.
We're assholes.
Every time someone uses the studio, there's a problem. Simple as that. We're assholes?
That's what we are. We're the assholes.
I think so.
Yeah. That's how it works. What the fuck is this?
We could have made it to 8. This? We could have just skated to 8 o'clock with some fun phone calls. Now we got to take another break and have Mars fix the phones, hopefully. Anthony.
Yeah.
I want to play this Derek thing from yesterday. It's terrific.
It really is.
We got into a discussion. Anthony just needs, like, Jim to graduate high school. It's been an ongoing thing on the show for many years. Ant's never going to go back to high school to take Jim to get his diploma.
Of course not.
But we had a little fun with the fact that Anthony never graduated high school. And possibly maybe he goes back to high school.
And it's a different story.
Right.
Jimmy thought it would make a nice comedy.
Great sitcom.
Like a great sitcom, mm-hmm. And started singing my little theme song. And Derek took it and put it to music.
Oh, he's older than the teachers, and he makes more money than the whole school. He's an alcoholic. He's Anthony. He's the oldest kid in class. He gets them drugs and fucks their heinies. His big delicious cock shouldn't be black, it's not. He's Anthony. Oh, he carries a trapper keeper full of Hitler photographs. He's Anthony. He's Anthony. He tries to be everyone's friend, but he gives all the girls the creeps. They think he's somebody's father who just showed up for no reason. He's Anthony. He's Anthony.
We'll try this again. Opie and Anthony. I guess we just blew off the phone topics. We had some good phone topics.
I know.
People wanted to talk about Harry Muffs. They wanted to talk about Mall Cop. They wanted to talk about The Hangover.
So many things.
What else? What else?
So many topics.
We need our phones for our show.
I know.
Sorry for all the filler, but we had guys in here like rewiring stuff and trying to figure out what's up with the phones.
Pain in the ass.
All good stuff to hear, but maybe not back to back to back to back.
No.
You're supposed to sprinkle that stuff in. A little bit here, a little bit there. Now what? I don't know what to do.
We could talk about all these checks I have. None of them are more than $22.
What are they from?
There's 13 of them. All these
are
Lucky
royalty?
Louie, royalties for Lucky Louie. Yeah, I still get them, but it's funny. Like every time there's like a, they sell it to this network, whatever happens to it, it just gets less and less.
Yeah.
And now my check's like $23.
It's going to be down to like a couple of pennies.
Someday, sure.
Like Jerry, what was Jerry's show?
Seinfeld. The
happy, no, oh. I know it was Seinfeld. Seinfeld. But he kept getting a bunch of checks.
I think it was Super Fun Time Happy Hour.
Super Fun Time Happy Hour in Japan. He was the guy. And he kept getting one penny checks.
Who?
Jerry, on one of the episodes of Seinfeld.
Oh.
You know, that show he did.
That little show?
Little show named Seinfeld.
That's another one I might have seen two episodes of Seinfeld in my life.
Really?
Not for any, but I hear it's a great show. I don't know why.
Really? I was going to ask you if you like it or don't. Or
no, what I've seen of it was really well written. I mean, funny, yeah.
Hey, why is it important that we know Kenny Rankin died of lung cancer at the age of 69?
Kenny Rankin died.
Singer-songwriter?
Yeah.
No, Jimmy, come on.
Kenny Rankin? Of course.
What songs?
Never heard of him.
Oh, okay, good.
Who the fuck is he?
What was his big song? Anyone? Anyone? Anyone?
Didn't he write Memories?
No. Look, jerky.
Also, Slash's mother died of cancer overnight, age 62.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, a banana.
And our old friend, Bodden?
Yes. Michael?
Michael Bodden?
Yes,
yeah,
the car.
What about him?
Hope he's not dead.
No, but he's doing David Carradine's ghoulish autopsy.
Oh, he is.
Oh, good.
He got the job.
Wow.
I love it.
He's doing the ghoulish autopsy.
Damn, yo.
That Bodden loves death.
He loves it.
Does. God, he can't get enough of it.
Yes.
Kenny Rankin. What was his big hit, Danny? You know?
I have no idea.
That's the songs right there. A Song for You.
I think this is like his latest thing.
It's on the prep sheet, so he had to have
no idea.
One song we all know, I'm thinking.
I know the name.
You do know the name?
Yes. Is he a country guy, right? Was he?
American Pop and Jazz.
American Pop and Jazz, okay.
Who put him on the prep sheet?
Give us the hit.
Travis? Who is he?
I don't know, but usually when it's like the look, when something is the main headline on like Yahoo Entertainment, I figure, hey, you know what?
Someone
it
has
should
to know.
Probably be on the press.
Yeah, but what if he's a singer? Wouldn't we have his songs ready? Like or something?
Dude,
that he
has like 100 songs in Dilette. I have no idea what he's...
All right, we're just looking for the big hit that he had.
Yeah, right, what's one of them?
He must have had a big hit. Start naming Kenny Rankin songs. Did he sing these, or did he just write them for other people?
I know I've heard his name, too. I have no idea who this fucking guy is.
On and On?
Or was.
He did On and On?
Stephen Bishop had a major hit with his song On and On.
On and On is like a 70s like
yeah.
Pop fluff. Give me a little On and On.
Fuck, this guy won't be missed.
Fuck.
Sorry.
Why are you angry?
I just don't. I don't think this guy will be missed.
Because he had one song he didn't like. All of a sudden, good. Glad he's off the earth. You're a tough critic, Ant.
You know this song.
Yeah, everybody knows this.
Yeah.
This isn't the version everybody knows.
Yeah, it is. This is Stephen Bishop.
No.
No?
This isn't the version. Travis is the king of the not the version everyone knows.
I'm the king of playing Kenny Rankin's On and On.
King of the trees.
Hey. No way, no how.
Tree, you're fucking king of the trees.
And me. No way.
No way.
Not once, not never.
Not never.
No way.
King of
no
the trees.
No way. Where's this garbage?
This isn't the version everyone knows.
Anyone knows is more accurate.
Yeah. You want Steve Bishop?
Yeah.
Well, right. Yeah.
See, what happens with these songwriters, they write these hit songs for other people. The other people may get a huge hit, and then the songwriter decides, you know what, I'm going to do my own version.
I'll do my own thing. There you go.
Right. You were right.
Now that's the version everybody knows.
Wait, no, Travis, get one that was sung at a birthday party in the Midwest in 1980.
You asshole. She's the love of the Lord, taken from the fire into the frying pan. Hey, remember this?
Kevin from Connecticut has some Stephen Bishop trivia.
No.
You want to guess?
Not really, but... No, okay, let's give it a try.
Don't look up there.
I can't look up there.
All right,
what's the trivia? Who the fuck is Stephen Bishop?
And I don't know if this is true. Ask a few questions. We'll get there.
All right. Isn't he going to ask
No, he's got... It's on Instant Feedback. He gave me a little Stephen Bishop trivia.
But Stephen Bishop was in Animal House.
You knew this!
Yes, he's the guy on the stairs playing the fucking guitar.
Did you look down?
Belushi. No, there's nothing. I have nothing in front of me.
How'd you know that?
Because I knew it was Stephen Bishop.
And that was Give My Love a Cherry or whatever the fuck? He sang that.
I gave my love a cherry that had no stone. I get it! And Belushi takes the...
And that was Stephen Bishop?
Yeah, that was
on the stairs?
Stephen Bishop.
Ah, right on. Kevin from Connecticut. And you knew that for real?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Why?
For real. I don't know. It's just one of those, like, Animal House trivia things.
Oh, God damn it. Give yourself a bell, motherfucker.
Righty.
The fuck you waiting for?
That's my bell.
Let's say hi to Ray in Philly. Ray, what's up?
Hey,
No! You don't have to call me Ray.
You can call me Ray.
Or you can call me Jay. Or you can call me Johnny. Or you can call me Ray J. Johnny. Or you can call me John Ray Johnson.
That is a funny bit.
Oh, it's hysterical.
It's terrific. Ray.
Hi, Ray.
Kenny Rankin, you guys are too young. Kenny Rankin was introduced by Helen Reddy as a very good songwriter, ex-drug addict.
Ex-drug addict?
He recovered from drugs, and Helen Reddy brought him out on his show. Because I got two of his albums, but I would have to pick his hits from a list.
Hey, this is Big Ray, by the way.
This is Big Ray.
Say hi to the rest of the Rays. The whole family's Ray.
Who's Ray, Big Ray? Ray?
Big Ray is very close to me and my family.
You doesn't have
Philly.
To call him Ray.
I'm going to use you guys to recover again. I had a major setback at work.
I heard. What happened? But you're gonna like freak
shut
out,
down.
Anthony. You got shut down.
Same thing happened to your phone system. Happened to my
brain,
my body.
Oh yes.
Jesus!
What happened?
Coming back.
What happened? You passed out.
I took a seizure and got CPR.
Jesus!
And the CPR is very very hard to recover from.
We helped him recover from a little brain surgery. Oof. And now he's back on the job. He had a little seizure.
Holy fuck.
His brain shut down like our phone system.
Getting the heebie-jeebies.
Yeah, you're freaking out, Aunt Big Ray.
You're a fun guy in the morning, Ray.
I was able to get the guys got me out of the crane. I locked everything down. Everything was cool, so
yeah.
I had a couple minutes' notice.
But everything's coming back?
Yeah, it's all coming back. I'm listening to you guys all the time.
All right, Big Ray. Hang in there.
I remember Kenny Rankin.
Yeah.
Already.
Hey, that's
apparently
good. That means the seizure wasn't too bad.
That means we have to question his information. He could be totally wrong. Helen Reddy could have nothing to do with this.
Can you imagine, Big Ray?
I can remember the 70s, not yesterday.
We might have to test you to make sure your brain's still there, Ray.
It could be all about Helen Reddy for this guy.
Can you imagine? He lost everything.
Everything's Helen Reddy.
Everything. Who was that? She was in Deep Throat. Helen Reddy. Everything's Helen Reddy, this man.
Yeah. He's obsessed. He lost everything except Kenny Rankin knowledge.
That's all he remembers is Kenny Rankin. And Helen Reddy. It's the answer for everything.
That would be very tragic. All right, Ray, I'm glad you're doing well, my friend.
All right, buddy.
All right. Say hi to the rest of the Rays. Big Ray, Little Ray, and what? Middle Ray, we call him?
The Horn. My last name's Horn, so it's the Horn section.
Yeah, the Horn section. All right. Thank you, Ray.
All right, thanks. I hope.
All right.
Care.
Yep. Let's say hi to JJ.
JJ.
Hey, morning,
JJ.
Hey, JJ.
JJ.
What's up,
hey,
man?
I just wanted to see if you guys had seen on What Would Tyler Durden Do? It was apparently an article out of the New York Times that was announced on Larry King.
It's ridiculous.
David Carradine's family doesn't believe that he committed suicide or died the way he did. He was murdered by black ninjas. Whose secret society he was working to uncover.
No, they actually, you know what they really think happened? They actually think that he was strangled by Helen Reddy. That's all I'm talking about for the rest of the day. Is
while
Helen
listening
Reddy.
To Kenny Rankin's On and On.
Kenny
song.
Rankin.
What's
Rankin.
A Helen Reddy song, Travis? I'm sure
oh,
you have heard
I Am
parts.
Woman, Hear Me Roar.
That's actually I Am Woman.
Hear Me Roar.
Hear Me Roar.
Give us a
and
little
I'm
Helen Reddy.
Too big to no ignore. Way.
Well, JJ, the problem there, I mean, the family, you know, they want to distract the fact that he had a rope tied around his cock.
Yeah.
I mean,
so wouldn't you come up with something like Black Ninjas?
Yeah, you got to come up with even the most ridiculous story kind of throws an element of doubt in there.
And gets people talking about other theories instead of the fact that he had a rope around his cock.
Rope around his cock. He was fucking jerking off.
Where was Opie? He is, after all, a Black Ninja fuckface.
Well,
all right,
JJ, we're going to enjoy some Helen Reddy now. Uh-oh.
If it's not Helen Reddy, I'm stabbing him with a fucking pen.
No, it has to be.
Uh-oh.
This sounded a little too twangy.
Wait a minute.
All right. He got it.
Yeah, that's Helen Reddy.
It's too big to ignore, and I know too much to go back and pretend. Cause I've heard it
all before,
and I've been down there on the floor. No one's ever gonna keep me down again.
Everybody.
Yes, I was.
But it's wisdom.
No way. No way. Quizzes garbage. Not me. No way.
No
not
way.
Once. Not never.
Not never. Not once. Not never.
All right. We're going to play the whole fucking thing?
Yes!
Jesus Christ.
It's all I'm all about Helen Reddy.
Yeah, name another Helen Reddy song, though. No one here could do that.
I am Quiff. Smell me roar.
Come on.
Delta
no
Dawn.
Delta Dawn. Wow.
What's that flower you have on?
That was Helen Reddy.
Yeah.
Delta Dawn. What's that flower you have
on? Later used in a parody on the Ron and Fez show.
Faded rose from days gone by.
What is this? This is Helen Reddy. Helen Reddy stinks. Taking care of the older demos today.
I am woman.
All right, enough of this garbage. No way, no how. Fuck
we used to sing. We used to sing a song to that song about Crazy John, who used to go behind the House of Beer in Elwood. Mm-hmm. It used to be the International House of Beer.
Was he called Crazy John?
Because he walked around with a shopping cart and went through the garbage and had a big sunflower, one of those, you know, those old sunflowers that used to spin. He had that on his shopping cart, and he would go around. And he was like, he was definitely like Sling Blade. And we called him Crazy John because he used to stay behind John's. And there was John's Bargain Store was in the same shopping center. And he would always be behind this, so we called him Crazy John. And then we wrote the song, Crazy John, what's that flower you have on? Could it be a faded daisy from Daisy's Gone By? Yes. The comedy, even back then, folks, I was a genius.
That's not bad. Yeah. Hey, remember that drinking from cups thing?
Drinking from cups.
Can we give the fine people another taste of that? Because we're trying to get a bit going. I don't know if it's going to work, but Kevin from Connecticut did send in the first one.
Oh, no.
We want people to attempt to do their version based on the O&A show.
Oh, boy.
No? Not much confidence
I hope so.
Can we hear Kevin's?
Yeah, but we need a reference point, so we need the original, just for the people that have never heard it. Drinking from cups.
Drinking from cups.
We try to play just the first, 30 seconds of this, but then we end up playing the whole thing, because it's good.
It's too goddamn funny.
All right, here we go.
What does this guy think? He's an Indian?
Drinking out of
Indian.
Cups.
Indian.
What is he, a goddamn asshole? What the fuck is he doing? Not ever. No way. Now he's Johnny Hammersticks.
Johnny
hammered away like
sticks.
Freaking Tommy Noble. What the hell is he doing? Thinks he's got it going, bossing over.
The
no way.
Great.
No way. What is this garbage?
Garbage.
What is this? Oh, I'm king of the trees. I'm the tree meister. I count on them. Well, sometimes I pry. I like to steal. Yeah, right. This guy's a faggot. Some sort of faggot Indian in the teepee. Ooh, this guy thinks he's Captain Knots. Thinks he's Captain Tying Knots. And everyone needs some knots tied. They go to him. Bullshit. Bullshit. This woman's such a bitch. Thinks he's Miss Sand. Drinking out of cups. Being a bitch. I bet her fist. I bet her fatalisk. Barned. Patterns going to pat a little kid in the background fucking going crazy. Who's this guy? Mr. Balloons. Mr. Balloon Hands. No way. Get real. Like those things. Mr. Walkway. Mr. Walk Down Me. I'm the walkway. Lead me to the building. Fuck you. 5-6-4-3. Yeah, right. You some stupid bitch. Who paid for that floor? Not me. No way. Never been for no floor ever again. Not once, not never.
Not once, not
nope. Whose chair is that? Who bought that goddamn chair? That's not my chair. Not my chair, not my problem. That's what I say. No way. Stupid dresses. Stupid flowers. Lighthouses rule. You don't like the lighthouse? You suck. What is this, seahorse captain?
Seahorse captain.
What, seahorse seashell party? Who didn't invite me?
Holy
Why didn't I get invited, seahorse seahell?
Why didn't
What is this? Get real. I'm in love with seahorses. I'm in love with them. They're so beautiful and cute. I'm in love with the seahorses. They're fucking unreal. I love them. They're like all the clocks. I love them. I love seahorses, and I love looking at them, and I love seashells. I love seashell things. I love things with seashells and seahorses on them, like blankets and towels and little bags. I love them. Seahorses. Forever.
Forever.
Fucking
forever.
A, man.
Is that fucking...
I love the one where he goes, bullshit.
Bullshit.
Yeah, of course bullshit. Everyone in the world would say bullshit to what you just said.
I'm like, I didn't buy this floor. Not once, not never.
So, Kevin from Connecticut came up with this. After playing the original, this is going to be a tough spot for you, Kevin. I'm telling you right now. Tough spot. But let's give it a shot, see what happens.
Yeah.
What does this guy think? He's an angelfish? Was he a goddamn asshole? What the fuck is he doing? Not ever. No way. Now he's Kenny Angelfish face. Hammering away like he's friggin' Tommy Throwdown. What the hell's he doing? Thinks he's got it going bossa nova. No way. No way. What is this garbage? What is this? Oh, I'm king of the boners. I'm the Cialis Meister. I show you my tent. Well, sometimes I fronkus like the Blurka. You're right. This guy's a faggot. This guy's some sort of faggot hoagie on the Friggy ride. This guy thinks he's Captain Mayo. Thinks he's Captain Garlic Butter Sauce. When everyone needs some halitosis, they go to him. Bullshit. Bullshit. He's such a bitch. Thinks he's Miss Cinnamon. Shitting in two cups. Being a bitch. I better fist a burg. Little twink in the background fucking going crazy. Who's this guy? Mr. Hobo Kisser? Mr. Man Kiss? No way. Get real. Like those things, Mr. Hallway. Mr. Run Down Me on the Hallway. Lead me to the studio. Fuck you. 5643, you're right. Here's some hair plug, bitch. Who paid for that gun? Not me. No way. Never paying for no gun ever again. Not once, not never.
Never.
Nope. Whose pair of capris is that? Who brought that goddamn flame shirt here? That's not my blouse. Not my problem, that's what I say. No way. Stupid foundry. Stupid logo. Satellites rule. If you don't like the satellite, you suck. What is this? A captain giveaway? What, a money party? Who didn't invite me? Why didn't I get invited, Timmy 10 grand? What is this? Get real. I'm in love with the outcasts. I'm in love with them. They're so beautiful and cute. I'm in love with the rejects. They're fucking unreal. I love them. They're like all the Wednesday tits. I love them. I love boobs. I love looking at them. I love decoupage. I love decoupage things. I love things with wiffle ball bats and phones on them, like blankets and towels and little bags. I love them. 01A forever.
Yeah, that's not bad, Kevin.
That's not bad. He did it all show related, but
we hung right in there.
Yet gibberish.
That was pretty good. Kevin from Connecticut, shitting into cups.
He had the right tone.
Yep.
I liked it. Gotta tell you, I liked it.
Liked
funny.
It a lot.
Bullshit. No way. I can love that. No way shit.
That's quite the thing.
No way.
What do you got, E-Rock?
E-Rock.
E to the rock. What do you got? Bill Burr. That's right. Bill Burr was the first comedian on Conan.
Oh, he did the stamp?
He's now a trivia question.
Wow.
He was the first one. You want to take a little listen?
Damn, yo.
You got the whole set? Should we just go whole set? Want to do a whole set?
Yeah.
I'm sure it went well.
Set.
Bill Burr on Conan O'Brien last night, the first stand-up comedian. That's huge for Mr. Burr.
Yes, it is.
Also, I hear he's going to be filming a movie in New York or something.
Really?
That was in the paper yesterday,
No way.
Too. Yeah.
Get real.
Yeah.
But we're back. My next guest is a comedian who will be appearing at the Denver Comedy Works from July 23rd to the 25th. His special,
Why Do I Do This is now available on DVD and CD. Please welcome very funny man, Bill Burr.
Thank you. Jeez, that's a long walk. I didn't think I was going to make it. How are you? Fantastic. I think I'm slowly going crazy. I was on YouTube last night for an hour and a half watching people get bit by poisonous snakes. Just having the time of my life. You know, just screaming at my computer, that's what you get, you dumb bitch. You know, I don't even know what that means. I do it every single night. 4 hours I spend on YouTube. This is how I break it down. The first hour, I watch fat people fall off of stuff, you know, just to take the edge off the day. Then I watch animals attack people, a couple of slap fights. Then I watch conspiracy theory. I let it marinate all in my head. And then I go to sleep and have like these Pink Floyd acid trip dreams where Dick Cheney's like half a cat crawling towards me. Ah! Ah! That's why I don't have any kids. I don't. I love kids, but I think it's irresponsible to be a complete maniac, not work on yourself, and then just have a kid, you know, and just start downloading all your crazy thoughts onto their pristine little hard drive. Then you just send them off to school. They start freaking out the other kids. You want to play in the sandbox? My daddy keeps cash in the walls because he doesn't trust banks. Daddy says they're all whores. I love kids, though. I like them when they're little. I don't like when they get a little bit bigger, you know, when they start thinking like they know stuff, you know? They start sitting, my buddy's kid's like that, you know? The other night we're standing in the driveway. I'm like, hey, look at the stars are out. He goes, actually, that's Jupiter. Jupiter is the fifth planet. I'm like, all right, shut up. Good Lord, I knew that for a week when I was in fifth grade, too. You know? I saw a stripper quit on stage 2 weeks ago. What are you honestly going to tell me? Couple of strip club people, there you go. I don't know why you'd want to have a kid anyways. I think they're getting ready to microchip all of us, you know? You guys seen that creepy new commercial where that they're trying to sell batteries where that woman can't find her kid in the park? You know? What kind of way is that to sell batteries? Remember back in the day when they would have a battery commercial? They just show some guy in a rainstorm, pulls out a flashlight. Oh, thank God I had fresh batteries. I can see how wet I'm getting, right? Now they're showing this woman she can't find her kid in the park. She's sitting there going, Kevin? Kevin? Hey, has anybody seen Kevin? Sitting there freaking out. Then she pulls out this little device. Beep, 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 beep. And there comes Kevin running out of the woods. And they're like, Duracell batteries. I'm like, dude, the hell with the batteries? What was that thing she just took out of her pocket? You know? How did Kevin know to come out of the woods? He didn't have an antenna. His sneakers weren't glowing. What the hell is in Kevin? Don't just show me that like that's normal. Oh, yeah, remote control kid. Yeah, must go see mommy. Dude, that is some psycho New World Order stuff. I think bankers run the world. I think that's what it is. Nerds. Isn't that depressing? Nerds run the world. Remember those kids in fourth grade who'd strike out playing kickball? Which is literally physically impossible at that age. The ball's like half the size of your body, yet somehow they do it. You know, big swing and a miss, penny loafer flying down the third baseline. I was having lunch with this girl the other day, right? Right in the middle of lunch, she looks across the table from me and she goes, this is going to seem oddly racist. And I was like, all right, this is going to be awesome. Never heard a conversation started this way. She's like, there are a lot of Asians in this restaurant. I'm like, that's not racist. That's an observation. There are a lot of Asians in this restaurant. Now, if you were to say, what the hell are all these Asians doing in this restaurant? That would seem oddly racist. You still haven't said anything bad about Asians, but you definitely seem to have a problem with them being in a restaurant, which is odd. Because I've never heard any bad stereotypes about Asians in restaurants, you know? Oh, they're taking up all the tables, just being all Asian, you know? I think about killing myself sometimes. Yeah. No, it's weird. You know why? Because it's never over anything big. Little things. Like I thought about killing myself on Thanksgiving because I said I was going to make a pie. This is what it was. 2 weeks before Thanksgiving, my girlfriend was all excited. She's like, Thanksgiving's coming. I'm going to make a turkey. I'm going to make stuffing. What are you going to do? So I panicked. I'm like, I'm going to make a pie. She's like, you can make a pie? I didn't know you could make a pie. I'm like, yeah, I'm making the best damn cream pie you ever had. I don't want to make a pie. I was just trying to make her leave, right? So it worked. No, she walked away totally excited. I completely forgot about it. 2 weeks later, it's Thanksgiving. She's like, oh my God, it's Thanksgiving. You're going to make that pie, right? You're going to make a pie? And I was like, oh my God, I got to go to the grocery store. I got to buy some flour. Then I just started thinking, you know, what if I just slam my head right through this plate glass window and just bled out right down the side of the house? You know, I wouldn't have to make the pie. So it's not even like I'm suicidal. It's more like I'm like lazy. You know what I mean? Like whenever I know the next 4 hours of my life is going to suck, like I think about it. Like, oh God, I gotta pay my taxes. It's gonna be a long line at the bank, and then a bus comes by. What if I just dove head first right behind those double back tires? All right, I'm out of time. You guys are a lot of fun. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Hey.
Thank you, Tom.
Bill Burr, hilarious. Thank you so much.
Look at Bill, huh?
Fucking firing those jokes off.
They weren't a great crowd, and Bill just took it and really turned them around, man. Bill's funny, man.
Absolutely.
Really funny.
Very good for Bill Burr. Very happy for him.
Yeah, that's a great job, man. Damn. Goddamn Bill.
Mm-hmm.
Fucking Bill Burr. Right. Forget it.
Telling his jokes.
Jokes.
Yeah.
The joke meister.
The joke meister. He's king of the jokes.
You don't like red hair, you suck.
All right.
That's fantastic.
A lot of, by the way, a lot of people, I want to just clear this up, are asking me, like, what is with Florida?
No one's asking that.
Dude, I can't tell how many emails. I'm coming.
Well, you know what? Probably clear it up just by saying it here.
Yeah.
That's a good idea.
I will be in Fort Lauderdale on the 18th and the 19th, 20th, West Palm. It's not all the same place. Mm. Stop being confused.
Yeah, stop.
It's not complicated. It's two places.
Right.
You'd be in Miami?
No. I'm not. I was kind of kidding with the setup, but it's amazing the emails you get. Like, I announced I'm doing Fort Lauderdale and West Palm, and then you get an email, Tampa? ?
No.
No, like, what proximity makes it appropriate to ask? Anything below Mason-Dixon? Georgia? No, I'm not doing Jacksonville. I won't.
So you're doing Jacksonville and Tampa?
Yes, I am.
Okay, good.
But I'm doing one Tuesday, September 8th, and then I'm doing one on New Year's Eve.
Okay.
And I guarantee I'll get an email about that. Dude, are you kidding? Yes.
So what's the real info? Now I'm confused.
Fort Lauderdale and West Palm.
There you go.
June 17th through 19th.
Very good. We never got the home run call from John Sterling.
Yeah, where is that?
I want to hear that. That ain't a good sign.
It's not Danny's responsibility. Dan is in studio.
I'm sure Sam's looking for it.
They're still trying to find it.
Those are tough to find, right? Anyway, especially when it's just so broad like that.
All right.
Do we know what? Yeah, we don't know what any it was.
Sam looking for it.
Let me say hi to Tom in Chicago. Tom.
Hey Tom.
Guys. Welcome aboard, Thomas.
Hey Tom, how are you?
Happy birthday, Yummy.
Aw.
Hey, did you guys catch that he slipped in the word cream pie into his set?
Well, cream pie is a cream pie.
Yeah,
I don't think he was trying to be, like, silly with it.
Yeah, I don't think he was.
It's just a cream pie.
I think you're the best cream pie you ever. Oh, yeah. You know what? Maybe Bill is a bowl preparer and doesn't even know it. Bill likes to prep bowls. He has no idea.
Subliminal.
Yeah, prepping bowls, right.
Yeah, right. Don't fuck my girl. No way, no how.
No way, no how.
No way.
What are you, the cummeister?
No way.
Somebody sent me a clip that, what the fuck is it? I think it's from The Office. They were talking about cuckolding.
Really?
Yes. I'll find the link. I got it on my email or something. Oh, there's a video I want to turn you guys on to, another video.
It's cracking up.
Philly Fuck. If you go to my Twitter and go down a little bit, you see this?
Is that MySpace and Twitter?
MySpace. What did I say?
My Twitter.
My Twitter.
Oh, my Twitter, yeah.
It's but you meant your Twitter.
Go down a little bit.
A little bit.
There's a video a little further. It was from the weekend.
The weekend.
From Philly. Fuck, I think. Keep going. Heather, that was... Oh, boy.
Oh, no.
Oh.
Oh,
Oh, no.
Yeah. Have you guys seen this video yet?
I don't know.
I know. Well,
no.
I was just a setup. Ricky?
My.
Listen to Ricky.
Kelsey, you manipulate me.
Oh, no.
You manipulate my mind. You manipulate my heart.
Oh, boy.
You tell me.
Can you pause this? We might have to start over.
One.
What is this guy's fucking story?
Well, you don't really... We could give you the visual very easy. He's on a webcam. Very pissed off because I guess his girlfriend did him wrong.
He's a lunatic.
He has crazy eyes, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Short black hair, kind of a goatee thing happening.
Exactly.
Dark eyes that are just crazy.
Yeah. He looks like Steve wants to look.
And he is not happy. He's got wood paneling and horrible drapes behind him. Obviously living with, I would say grandma, not even mom. And he talks to, I think, what is his ex. Here we go.
Poor girl.
That helped me get through my dad's death. You were there for me.
Oh, boy.
How I promised my dad that he would meet the girl of my future before he dies.
Holy
and
shit.
And that you were the one.
Wide eyes into the camera.
And then,
looking away from the camera.
Today, you have the audacity to go out with someone else.
Oh, shit.
After telling me that you were falling back in love with me.
Oh, shit.
Oh, boy.
That shit don't fly with me.
Ooh.
No, huh?
Tough talk.
I may have been dating Jess. I didn't love her, and you knew that.
Yeah.
Use your fucking mind.
What a bad actor.
Right.
Of course, you don't have one.
Ooh.
They're too fucked up with drugs and alcohol and all the other poisoning. You go out with someone who you said raped you.
Oh, what?
The ex-heavyweight
you
champ.
Keep getting your heart broke. You keep going back to the same guy. Same guys over and over and over. At least I don't do that.
Yeah.
I'm not gay.
Fact is, you want to manipulate my mind? You want to manipulate my heart? You want to try and break me down?
Yeah.
It's not going to happen. I'm a lot smarter than that. I'm a lot smarter than a lot of people give me credit for.
Uh-oh. Are Fredo. You?
I'm smart.
But if you want to try and destroy me and go that low, say, oh, I love you. I'm falling back in love with you.
He's
and you're
like,
not.
He's like cockeyed.
Yeah, he's awful.
Do me a favor. You do those drugs. You do that alcohol. You end up dead. And you burn. Burn in hell. Rest in peace, bitch.
How fucking embarrassing.
Ugh, and that's now that's forever.
The teeth clutch.
Yeah.
Can we please hear the end
He's
part
like,
again?
Rest in. There he goes. This is clenched teeth.
Hell. He's trying to be
and you
intense.
Burn in hell. Rest in peace, bitch.
Shit.
Louis Beans.
What else does he have up, Daddy?
He's a lunatic. His name's Ricky.
Well, that was off of some guys. It's not his own. It's not his own post. It's from his Facebook page. Uh-huh.
What do you think?
I think he's unstable.
You can see it in his eyes, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, like anybody could act like that, I guess. But he's got those crazy eyes that just make him crazy.
They get wide, then he's clenching his teeth.
And one goes one way, one goes the other.
Crazy.
He tries to look away from the webcam a few times.
Yeah, he can't.
Poignant.
He's cockeyed.
Yeah, he's doing bad actor things.
Yeah. Right.
But you don't think that's fake, do you, Jimmy?
No.
Oh, okay. Because you said
bad
actor.
Oh, no, I mean, not that he's a bad actor in the video, but when he says he's looking away and looking back, like he's trying to be dramatic,
yeah.
It doesn't work with me. But obviously, it works perfectly well with him.
Of course.
Of course it works with him. Burn
in
hell.
Hell. He thinks he's, I think he looked at it and looks at, like, actors and sees what they do and tried to emulate that. doing a very poor job. I couldn't see where his hands were. See if he was a good actor. Yes.
Fortunately, they weren't on a gun.
In his mouth.
Yes.
Let's go to Sergio in New York. Sergio.
Sergio.
Good evening.
Hey.
That guy who just did that rendering sounds like Primetime Sam. Maybe he can do a, you know, read it out.
Bit.
Some people said it sounded like Ron Howard. Gamer Dad really? Said Ron Howard. Let's go to Brad in Atlanta. Brad.
Hey, boys, you got to get Ricky on the show. He's my new hero. He's awesome.
You like Ricky?
He's hilarious, dude. Punching out.
He's hilarious.
He seems a little dangerous. Well, I don't think I'd like to have him around.
No.
Get out of here.
Best rant of all time, filthy fucking rant by Earl Weaver. Yeah, we've played that many times over the years. Maybe we could squeeze it in today for Mark Patch in Boston. Hear what a Yankee fan did in Boston? Anyone? Anyone?
Let me think.
Anyone? It might be on this one.
A Yankee fan. Was it something good?
Something with the Green Monster, I think.
Yes, Green Monster.
He throw himself off of it?
I'm trying to figure out. I didn't feel like reading the whole story, but why would I? Ron Valeri taught me. You read the first two lines of any story, and then you got pretty much the whole story.
Like,
try it at home.
Add the details yourself.
Try it at home. It kind of works.
If anybody needs to know any more than that,
or the first,
just make it up.
Or the first paragraph, I think he said. First paragraph.
I would hope it's the first paragraph.
And then the rest of it is just filler.
Filler.
Of the story that they just told you in the first paragraph.
You would just want to know who, what, when, why.
I guess a Yankee fan decided to get some grass seeds from Yankee Stadium, I think. That might have been in you know, more of the paragraphs that I didn't read.
Yeah, right.
He put it in a baggie, put some water in the baggie, and then he was at a Red Sox game, and he might have been hanging out around the Green Monster or so, and threw it onto the field, hoping that just one seed from Yankee Stadium starts growing at Fenway.
Ah.
And that actually made the news today.
What a nut.
Could you give me the paper? Maybe I should read this one.
I don't know which paper is it in.
I don't know either, Jimmy. I don't know.
What a dumb sentiment that is.
It really is.
Give me the paper while you rant, because I got to find the whole thing.
It really is.
Because I knew this would bother you.
I just have had enough of baseball, and I've had enough.
Why? What's wrong with baseball, Jimmy?
I'm sick of the baseball purists fucking bellyaching about steroids, and I'm sick and tired of these traditions and... So they buried the jersey in Yankee Stadium. They don't. Shut up.
I'm tired of your belly aching.
Well, I guess he's getting the Red Sox back for the guy that buried the Red Sox jersey in the Yankee
fun
Stadium.
Fun rivalry.
I think that's what this is about. Let me try to find the story.
Why does he take a big dump in the shape of an N and a Y on home plate? You want to make a statement at Fenway? That's what you do. Shit the Yankee logo.
That's a statement.
Yeah.
I think we would pay... a lot of money for that, Jimmy. First person to shit the Yankee logo at Fenway.
Wins?
I might have to go to the second paper, so this could take a minute. So talk among yourselves. What? It is? All right. What section? The sports? Must be, right?
Do you think they'll replace my fucking exploded battery?
No.
Yes.
They better.
Will they ask me when it was from?
Yeah, probably. How old is it?
Might be a couple years. But even if it's old, should it do this?
Never.
I don't care how old it is.
You shouldn't have a problem.
It shouldn't explode.
That's ridiculous.
Mm-hmm.
It's crazy. Exploding batteries.
Yeah. Yeah. Put it back in your laptop. No way, no how. Fucking
no way.
The battery hands.
No way. Why read when we got a guy that read for us? Tim in Boston. Tim, what do you got on this story?
The guy actually was at the Fish concert last weekend and he did it. He's a lifelong Yankees fan. He thought it would be funny. He's from Vermont.
But who reported it?
Yeah, why is it a story? It's page two down here, by the way. Page two in the paper. Let me read. Stay on the line to help us out, Tim. The Yankees will have home field advantage at Fenway Park tonight thanks to one fan's grassroots effort to sabotage the Red Sox.
I get it.
I didn't know you could like put grass puns into a news story.
Yeah,
amazing.
Let's see. Oh, that's why the headline says Yank fan puts Green Monster in Fenway. See,
because it's a green, it's literally a monster because it's grass from
Yankee Stadium. Ian Ferris, a Bombers fan in the heart of Red Sox Nation, green-thumbed his nose. How many fucking puns?
What the fuck?
They are really trying for the puns.
I think that's three or four already.
Little too hard.
Puns are awful.
Green-thumbed his nose at Boston by planting Yankee Stadium grass in the Fenway infield during the May 31st Fish concert. Yankee Stadium grass seeds went on sale this year. Ferris hid the seeds in his pants as he entered Fenway, filled the bag with water, and tossed it onto the infield. This is payback, said Ferris, who manages a Hooters in Vermont.
I've had seed in my pants.
and then it said, if even one blade of grass sprouts on the field, I feel it was a success.
It wasn't. It was a dismal, boring failure. Where your grass is, it's all over some hippie's foot in the parking lot. Bunch of dopey fish fans. They all stepped on it and carried it out.
Killed
with them
it.
And smoked it.
Know what's weird, though? And back me up, Tim. You guys are such lunatics up there that I bet you they replace the infield grass now.
Yeah, they probably do.
They're going to have to.
Yeah.
Well, I was there on Saturday at the game, and they actually walk through the infield and pick up anything that isn't the grass. So I'm sure they already pulled it out.
They don't know which blade it is, Tim.
Yeah,
well, listen, hey, fungus. Oh. They actually have five guys that walk through and pick, like, the lint out of the grass. So I'm sure they pulled it out.
No, pulled what out? Seeds?
They're seeds with water. What, do you think they drain the water, too? Yeah, they walk with a hairdryer.
He didn't just throw the whole baggie down there.
Yeah, he kind of, like, yeah.
You reckon they put a piece of sod down?
Give it a whoosh.
A willful boy in Jersey writes, page two is on page one of my Denny's placemat.
Oh, wow.
So that's good.
Denny's placemat.
Let me say hi to Cindy in Jersey. Cindy.
Cindy.
Hey, guys. How are you?
Pretty good.
Happy birthday, Jimmy.
Thank you.
My boyfriend and I went to the Dave Matthews Band concert at Fenway Park 2 weekends ago.
God, that sounds fun.
Wow.
Not a big Dave Matthews fan. Hold on, Cindy, because I like where you're going, but I want to...
I don't know what song he does. I know what I've heard of him, I thought he was... It was like listening to fucking... to Led Settle. It was just dull.
What would you say?
Can I have a little Dave Matthews?
Willie Nelson opened. That was a little worse.
No, Willie Nelson still rocks.
Yeah, to all the girls he's loved before.
Willie Nelson has dementia. Like, he's lucky he remembered the lyrics to his own song.
He smokes a lot of pot.
Yeah. Anyway, with the Green Monster was definitely accessible, and everybody was all over it. My boyfriend's shtick is to moon everybody everywhere, like he's notorious with his friends for pulling his pants down.
Cool.
So we're standing against the Green Monster, him being a lifelong Yankee fan, and I'm leaning against him, and he goes, "Don't move." I was like, "Why? What's the matter?" I thought like there was a bug on me or something, being that I'm a chick. He's like, "Don't move." And I feel him moving around. Next thing I know, he's wiping his ass against the Green Monster, and he's like, "That was the all-time best moment of my life ever." But he didn't warn me so I could get a picture of it.
Meanwhile, there's dirty cleat marks, and he's rubbing his asshole where all these fucking men's knees
exactly.
have been. Guys have spit tobacco there.
He's that much of a Yankee fan, he could care less. He said if he knew he was going to have the opportunity, like he wouldn't have wiped for a week just to make it even worse.
So you're saying he wasn't able to get a smudge on the actual wall?
I don't think so. don't think so. He probably tried his best, but I was blocking the view of the bodyguards and security and all that, so we didn't get thrown out. But unfortunately, I couldn't get a picture because I didn't know what was going to happen.
How was the show?
The show was phenomenal.
How long did Dave Matthews play for?
He plays forever.
About 3 hours.
Yeah. Ah!
Oh, wow.
Can I hear a little? I don't know what I've heard.
You know Dave Matthews, Jimmy. Doesn't mean you like or
what song
it
is
out.
This
is what would you say? What would you say?
All right.
Yeah.
The beginning threw me, but.
Sounds a little like the Spin Doctors.
A little bit.
In the beginning,
this is atrocious.
Right?
Just boring.
What's boring about it? It's just like
harmonica.
Nice.
It's fucking
nice
awful. This fucking blows.
Jimmy loves it.
What's wrong with this?
What's right with it?
It doesn't hurt anyone.
Fucking heinous.
We're just going to get to the hook for you, Jimmy.
Oh, yeah, I've heard this. Sounds like fucking music that lawyers enjoy. This is lawyer music.
That's, you know.
That's exactly it.
Right.
They lose their fucking ties.
Getting a little crazy on the weekends?
Yeah, this is like Moira fucking office guy music. It's atrocious.
Not your top 10, Jimmy?
I'm sorry, sweetheart.
Is it not your top 10?
No, it's not my,
You ever go to a barbecue where you don't know people and, like, the real conservative guy shows up with his casual outfit, but it was so not casual, it was, like, planned out to be casual?
You tell he's still the stuffed shirt.
Right. It's a tuxedo with a dildo on the outside or a strap-on.
Like, everyone else is just kind of wearing, like, long shorts and whatever, some T-shirts, and he has his casual, like, look, I can be cool too, guys.
What's another Big Dave Matthews song?
Well, Crash.
I have heard that hook.
A little Crash Into Me or whatever that fucking song is.
Crash Into Me.
No, Travis, we just heard this.
Every day.
This is another song?
Yes.
A little plinking guitar.
Yeah.
He's got a new album out. He was promoting.
Oh, thank God.
You weren't into Dave Matthews either then?
No. Sounds like that other guy.
Into your heart. Right, the heart. Enough with the fucking heart.
What's wrong with the heart?
Everything. I'm sick of it.
There's not a lot of songs
fucking
about the heart.
Boring cracker sentiments. Into your heart. Bunch of fucking medical assistants enjoying this. This is a bunch of dentists. This is great.
To your heart.
Dentists.
It's fucking awful. Put the radio on your Saab up and play this.
You don't like Saab, really?
You don't like songs about the heart in general?
I loathe them.
You do?
You loathe.
All right, Cindy, I got to move on to a lawyer who is offended by Jimmy. Let's say hi to John in Jersey. John.
Jimmy, I am so offended. Why? How could you say something like that about lawyers?
That you're not a Dave Matthews fan?
No, I am not.
I apologize.
Thank you.
I apologize to all lawyers.
Hi, John.
All right. Let's say hi to Tom in Jersey. He's a lawyer, and you love Dave Matthews?
Good evening.
Hey, what's up, Tom?
I love Dave Matthews, man. I've been to about 30 shows. All my lawyer friends have been to about 30 shows. We love Dave Matthews, man. Jimmy hit it right on the head. He's absolutely right. And I'm ashamed.
How does Jimmy know this stuff?
I'm ashamed.
I just sense it.
You just sense the fact that lawyers would like Dave Matthews?
It's just the type of music that you could just pick them kicking back to a beer and kind of listen to the words.
Oh, this one's a cool one.
Oh.
It's not a cool one.
No.
It's like every shitty fucking beer commercial, guys letting their hair down. Fucking stinks.
I love that you're angry.
The angry
Jimmy.
Part just makes me very happy. Instead of just like, it's not for me. He just gets really annoyed.
As they get fucking at their barbecues, they get a little drunk, they crank this up.
Oh, yeah. They're having a good time, Jim.
They sure are.
Just having a good old
good
time.
Good friends, good times.
Right.
Someone nods and they hold up their fucking imported beer.
Let's go to Roy in New York.
Fucking
Roy?
Yes.
Hey, Roy.
Stop putting, like, stuff from 20 years ago.
What? These are the hits. What do you want from me?
Yeah.
Sorry the guy hasn't had a hit in 20 years.
If we're going to talk about Dave Matthews, you got to play the hits for Jimmy because he doesn't even know the band.
Yeah, Roy.
He's got new hits. This shit's dark.
What's a new hit?
Now. It's very dark. Play Bartender.
Play Bartender.
That bartender make me a drink. Hey, buddy, drinking.
You gotta have it.
All right, I'll play Bartender.
Is it like that?
What are you drinking?
Come, Papa.
Is this Bartender?
Yeah, it's got a long intro.
Oh, great. Thanks.
And he wants us to play new stuff. This song is 7 years old.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You just said play new stuff, and you just told us to play a song that's 7 years old.
7 years old?
Newer than the other shit.
All right.
Okay, by 2 years.
Oh, really? The other stuff was 9 years old?
Yeah, when was the last time Dave Matthews had a big hit? Was probably around, 2002, 2004.
Why are we...
One thing I know today, you either love him or hate him. There's no in between.
Hold on, this is it. Oh. It's like a soundtrack for a 90s movie.
Sounding more and more like Peter Gabriel, huh?
Yeah, that's his band?
It's supposed to be dark.
Yeah, that's his band, Jimmy.
Look,
fucking
it's...
Fat guy with dreadlocks.
He likes the brothers. He's got a few brothers in his band.
And Kevin Bacon next to him?
One of the Bacon brothers.
Who's that one black guy with a long face? That is the ugliest band I've ever seen. Next to Dave Matthews, the three ugliest black guys in the country are in the Dave Matthews band. The white guys are actually.
Dave
Matthews.
I don't want to fuck them. I just want to listen to what they.
Hey, one guy's dead, you know.
The one guy.
Yeah,
looks
which
like,
guy died?
His saxophone side.
What did he do? Of course, saxophone. Fucking. Of course, he played. There's a sax player.
He's depressed. Look at the long face.
The guy in the middle kind of looks like Eminem. Dave Matthews has a fucking giant skull. His head gets bigger as it gets as you go up. It's awful.
His hairline's receding a bit there.
Well, he's in the foreground of the photo, Jimmy.
It doesn't matter.
His head
not that
looks
close.
Bigger than the rest of the guy.
He's not that close. It's not a Google fucking Earth image.
Then he's also 7 foot tall, too.
Is he that big?
No, but look, he's so much taller than everyone, too.
All right, I tried punching out.
All right, thank you for trying.
Oh, his fucking over-the-shoulder look.
Well, let's,
this thoughtful glance.
We get this phone call every time we talk about music. Let's go to Jeremy and Charlotte.
Jeremy doesn't know what he's talking about.
Jeremy.
Okay, here we go.
Well, because it's not Gene Simmons. It's not a good band, Jimmy.
No, I accept. I'll accept criticism of Gene.
Because Kiss is wicked awesome.
Well, Kiss is not what we're talking about. We're talking about Dave Matthews. Wow. Kiss knows better than to play for 3 hours, and they don't have the three ugliest black guys in the country in their band.
Dude,
I saw better-looking guys in Oz. That's fucking... they're awful band members.
You know how many songs Kiss would have to play if they played for 3 hours? Every song is, what, 3 minutes long?
Exactly. They get to the point.
That would be... They would have to,
they'd have to play
60
in the
songs. Right? Is that true? Wait, 20, right? 60 songs.
Come Roland just texted me.
Yeah, what did he say?
Dave Matthews is the music you play when you find out you just got AIDS. Bruce! There you go.
He's such a Springsteen fan.
Yeah, and a couple of Springsteen songs I'm really starting to love, but I don't like his high energy stuff. Bam, bam, that glory days is terrible.
Glory days, bam, bam.
However, Youngstown I love, The Hitter I love. I like his weird slow shit.
Yeah,
a lot.
You like the song from The Wrestler?
I have to hear it again, but like Philadelphia is a fucking amazing song.
What about droning and boring? In my hometown.
I like that.
In my hometown. All right.
What about Tunnel of Love?
I don't know that one.
Let's go to Brian in Maryland.
It is Tunnel of Love.
Brian.
Hey, what's up, guys? It sounds like Adam Sandler singing.
What, Dave Matthews?
Yeah. And I think the saxophone player is dead. He's dead. Paul Spook.
What happened to the sax player?
Jesus.
I don't know. Probably with Diesel or something. I don't know. I heard he's dead.
God.
Was he sick or
was his mind?
Was he sick or was it like...
Hey, Jimmy, I
got an axe in the chest when he went to the Overlook.
What's that, sir?
I love a meaty pussy, Jimmy. I like to look like a ham sandwich.
Yeah, I do too, man. I like a
fucking beef.
Yeah,
I like cold cuts. Apparently.
He sure does.
All right, let's go.
It should look like a Subway sandwich that a truck has just run over. It should look like a fucking three meat Subway sandwich that a truck has run over.
That's a little too much, you know?
A disemboweled sandwich.
Sandwiches.
Sandwich.
Chad in PA.
Hey, you guys realize you're probably going to get spanked by Powers That Be for this one again. They've got Channel 56 has Dave Matthews Radio right now. They've been promoting the shit out of it on your channel.
Dude, there's nothing I'm going to say that's going to affect Dave Matthews' popularity. Yeah, the guy's massive.
They're promoting the shit out of the Dave Matthews channel on our fine channel?
I know he sucks. You know he sucks, but it's everywhere. They're promoting it on your channel on Raw Dog. I know that.
Cool.
The only two things I listen to.
What would management say?
Oh, no. I bet they'd be angry.
They sure would be, Anthony. They sure would be.
Yeah. All right, just got to the office punching out, boys.
God, imagine if all of a sudden I just trashed Dave Matthews for 3 minutes and his record sales plunged. If I had that kind of power, do you know what a cunt that would be?
Of course.
Let's go to Keith. And
I'd have to keep doing it.
To everyone. Even people I liked, I would just boss around. I'd trash Ozzy, watch his fucking record sales go down, then make
their careers.
Then make myself a hero by bringing him back up. Thank you, Jimmy.
That's Jim's dream.
No kidding.
It's like being hugged by Kiss.
I think that's an actual dream he had. Keith in Louisville.
Hey, yeah, I got drugged at one of these concerts last year. I figured it out about halfway through. 1 minute into every song, it sounds exactly the same. And that black guy, he looks just like Barbaro, the horse that won the Derby.
He really is. What a long, thin head that guy has.
Wow,
yeah,
Keith.
He plays the violin.
We might have to bring Line of the Day back just for Keith, because that would... It would be right up there.
What did the sax player die of? Now I have to know. He's like the fatter guy, right?
ATV accident last year.
Oh, really?
That's what Joe in Baltimore is
saying. What the fuck did he
hit? I don't know. Yeah, maybe Dave Matthews' big head, because you said it's so big.
No, but he's kind of like, he has those like old guy, black guy dreads. Like when black guys are going bald, a lot of times they'll let dreads grow in.
Yeah.
Because it's a way of kind of covering area.
And it's like gray on the bottom.
Corey in Ohio. Corey?
What's up, O?
Hey, buddy.
Hey, you guys just don't understand. Dave Matthews is some pussy getting music. The ladies love it.
Probably right.
Let's go with this a little bit.
Really?
Name some of those.
Bruce isn't getting you no booty. Come on now.
Name some other artists that are pussy getting music.
Merciful Fate. I play that really loud. I'm saying, look, if you suck my dick, I'll turn it off.
Nah, you can't beat Dave, man. Half of his music is about getting pussy. Especially Crash Into Me. That's nothing but getting pussy.
You know what, Corey? He's making a pretty good point,
thinking. Back in the day, I was dragged to a Jackson Browne concert.
Is that pussy getting music?
And gave it up.
I think it was, yeah. Yeah, I was a pussy for going.
What about Jack Johnson? Pussy getting music?
No, you could call me Jack Johnson.
is that pussy
What's
getting
his
music?
Songs? I don't
what
know.
What does he do?
Well, Travis, you want to help me out with a little Jack Johnson?
Please, Travis.
He's got that surfer
for
thing
once.
Going. A little surfer. I don't know if you could even call it rock because he's on the softer side.
So we got vocals?
You know Jack Johnson.
I'd rather listen to James Blunt through a megaphone.
Oh, that guy.
James Blunt is...
You're beautiful.
That's pussy getting music,
yeah,
though.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, it's
the girls
to
eat
be.
That shit up. Eat yeah. that shit up. This is Jack Johnson.
Oh, you know where I saw this guy? I saw him at Bonnaroo. Okay, that's where I know the name.
Did you like him?
I was doing interviews and stuff. I didn't watch him.
Bonnaroo.
This is Dave Matthews.
It's pussy getting music. Corey is right.
It's background white guy music.
If regular radio was smart, they would have a whole fucking station just dedicated to pussy getting music. All their sweepers would be that, too. Pussy getting music. CWCU.
I know this song.
You know this one?
Yeah. Now it's ringing a bell.
Would you listen to this if it popped on something? Or would you turn the channel?
I'd probably turn the channel. Yeah. Yeah. Why bother? I sing your songs,
dance your dance. I'm going to, you know what? We're going to help Jim Norton out. Jenny Louisiana is going to help you out.
Okay.
You might appreciate Dave Matthews after this next phone call. Jenny, go ahead.
Hey, boys. Happy birthday, Jimmy.
Thank you, Jenny.
A couple of years ago, the Dave Matthews tour bus, I don't know what city it was in, but it was going over a bridge.
Yep.
And it accidentally dumped a whole shitter on this whole ferry full of people.
Oh, right.
On a ferry. That. Filled with people.
I think it was like one of those little, just like little tourist ferries. They got fined a bunch of money from the city for doing that.
You got like Dave Matthews now, Jimmy.
Shit and Dave Matthews.
How do you do that by accident? There was somebody that said, you know what, watch this.
Yeah.
Yeah, I did remember hearing about
There's
that.
No fucking way that was by accident.
Yep, later, I'm punching out.
All right.
Bye, Jenny.
Let me say hi to Mike in New York. Mike?
Mike?
Good evening.
Stupid.
It really is.
Good evening. This guy's the greatest.
You guys hit it right on the head. Me, I grew up in Westchester. You know, me and all my friends, you know, prep school upbringing, total stereotypical, you know, after school special stuff, sitting around, you know, smoking and listening to Dave Matthews. Every single one of us now works like in finance, IT, total white collar office douchebags. So you guys absolutely nailed it. And the saxophonist, I believe, died from an ATV accident.
That's one of those all-terrain vehicles. He just must have flipped it over and broke his neck or something?
Yeah.
Something like that. But you guys are great. You know, I actually wrote WOW on the back of my Humvee in Iraq and would have Army guys walk up to me and be like, you're helping Anthony Stone? That's awesome!
That's great.
The local women were flashing their eyes and noses.
Love it.
So you guys are great. I absolutely love you. You absolutely rock.
When
you guys went up here a little while ago, I stopped listening to my radio. Like, it just sucks.
If you ever went off the radio, I literally don't know what I would do with myself.
Well, I appreciate that, Mike. Thank you.
You guys rock.
And we need a new angle on that WoW thing. It's just sitting there. It's still happening, but we need a new angle. It's just tough to do it when you do morning radio.
Yeah.
It was perfect when we were doing afternoons. Perfect. Seal, pussy getting music?
Seal. I don't know. Not for me.
Here's one we talk about on the show a lot. Not a lot, but it comes up. Michael Bublé. The women love Michael Bublé.
Michael Bublé.
You put on some Michael Bublé, and they get moist instantly. Dave Matthew Band is frat and sorority music. Is that true, Ant? What do we know? Seal, pussy getting music?
What does he have? How many songs did he have?
I mean,
Kiss from a Rose, and what else?
Seal?
Yeah. One good song from the shitty Batman 2, and the rest of it's nonsense. Kiss from a Rose. Right, the Penguin, we know. What else? This is a great song, but what else?
I wouldn't call it a great song.
I like this.
It's catchy.
What's this?
This is Seal.
Oh, right.
Kiss from a Rose.
I know this one.
Didn't he just rework another one of his hits to make this song?
Probably.
I think.
Yeah.
Let me say hi to Matt in Jamestown. Matt.
Anal cunt, huge. Huge. Hey.
So a chick anal song cunt, you get pussy with.
Anal cunt was a band that wasn't thinking properly.
They weren't thinking about like
promotion, marketing, anything.
Yeah, yeah.
That's a band that could truly say, look, we're not in this to be famous.
Right.
And have a huge sellout audience.
Obviously.
Because what would they do if all of a sudden they started making hit records?
Well, for a while, people were just calling them AC if you tried to reference them on the radio, remember?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you know, AC. Oh, anal cunt?
Let's really wake up these fuckers. Do we have anal cunt in the master computer, Travis?
Anal cunt?
So much anal cunt. And
for real?
Oh, yeah. And they have the greatest names for their songs.
Yeah, read some of the names of anal cunt's music.
You guys
music.
Decide what you want. I'll read some names.
Oh, hold on a minute. Look, Sandra Bernhardt. Wow, I know that time's a bitch, but holy shit.
Oh, my God.
That's plastic surgery gone wrong there.
Yeah, something's happening. She's all
dude, bloated. I've always thought she was sexy. I really, Sandra Bernhardt was, she's a little older now, but I've always thought she was super sexy.
Older. Looks weird.
Her face is bloated. What happened?
Something going on.
Definitely something going on with Sandra Bernhardt.
Like it's even,
I love the gap in her teeth. That to me, fucking, when a girl has a little gap like that, I love it. I had a crush for years on a waitress with a little gap like that.
God.
Then she got it fixed and I punched it out.
Jimmy, your old friend makes pussy getting music. Did the show once.
Sully?
John Mayer.
Oh, yeah, of course.
JM.
Yeah.
Is pussy
and
getting
he gets
music.
All the pussy.
Yeah, he does. John also has a giant head, though. But yeah, he box swirls to him.
Anal cunt opened up for Pantera at the Worcester Centrum.
Are we going to get to hear some anal
cunt? Yeah. So what are some of the songs?
Right, why should it be all nice names like Sunday Surprise, Blueberry Medley, A Rose for My Dear.
For My Dear. It's A Rose for My Dear, a little band called Anal Cunt.
Would You Be Mine, You Goose? Go ahead.
Hitler was a sensitive man. I fucked your wife. I gave NAMBLA pictures of your kids. I got an office job for the sole purpose of sexually harassing. I intentionally ran over your dog. One of my favorite songs, I Just Saw the Gayest Guy on Earth.
Of course you did. You sing it into a mirror.
That song's hilarious.
Did someone ask for me?
Perfect, like
right
Squiggy.
In.
Hello.
Hello.
He just walked right in.
Yes, I have sunglasses on my head.
I lit your baby
swish,
on fire.
A swish. Sorry.
All right.
A swish.
We have a very important job here. We need the anal
to suck, and we're doing it.
We need the anal cunt fans to call. We're going to play one song that represents this band. What song is it? I don't know. I don't know.
I like
guys
how
whatsoever.
They have a song. Songs are I did something.
Yeah. They have a song called Radio Hit. That's probably their big hit.
I wouldn't want to hear
that.
Did
they redo Afternoon Delight? Kevin from Connecticut once again saying that.
It's not in.
I think it was.
I know they did a death metal version of the A-Team theme song.
Oh, really?
Jesus. Now they have a song, The Only Reason Men Talk to You Is Because They Want to Get Laid, You Stupid Fuck.
Oh, yeah, let's play that.
Playing a Sandra Bernhardt clip from King of Comedy right
she
there.
She was really kissable, man.
Sherry.
She gay or no?
I think so.
She's really sexy, man. How miserable is Jerry Lewis in this?
Jerry's wrapped in tape.
Oh, wait, here we go.
Jerry.
We got some AC for everybody.
Oh, AC. Stupid.
Jimmy's disgusted.
Why? Because of this fucking idiocy.
Why is it?
The music is fine.
Why is it idiocy?
It is.
I can't even say the word.
Why?
Why is it that word you use?
It's just nonsense. No one could listen to this to go, that makes sense.
Why? There are people that enjoy this. They continue to make music for them.
Again, the music is fine.
Yeah.
I would love to just put that on during a nice, like, candlelit dinner with a girl, like, that the first time you ever met her.
Well, the next time a girl goes...
Pregnant? Is that why she's gaining weight?
She has to be pregnant.
Is that Rachel Ray?
No.
That's Suki.
Who's Suki?
Suki or
she
something.
The news over there.
I don't know who Suki 11. Is.
She's on Jill's channel.
Well, I don't know who she is.
Aunt, you know how you get into a situation every once in a while and you're setting up something and then you go, hey, you want to hear? Yeah, I'm going to put some music on. What do you want to hear? And
they
go,
hear?
Whatever you want.
All right.
Then you grab the
a little anal cunt and you throw it on.
They have a 22-second song called Van Full of Retards.
All right, let's listen to that.
Van Full of
Retards. I don't even know. Hold on, guess. Blah, blah, blah! Retards, blah! Retards, dumb! Blah! Let me guess. Maybe you can understand.
All right, let's play our new game. We give you the title of an anal cunt song, Jimmy, and you tell us how it goes.
They'll all be that way.
Well, let's see if one is like that.
Maybe Travis should play an anal cunt song, and then Jimmy has to title
okay,
it.
Okay, yeah.
All right.
Let me hear the retard song.
Well, I want to hear the retard song.
Of course.
That's it.
Wow.
Yeah. Well, what bugs me about them is their song titles are too funny. It's almost like the whole point is just to get a funny song title. So they can go look and read the back of the album. It's like, who gives a fuck?
And then because all the songs just go...
dark. Ooh, the devil. Ooh.
Rebecca Marshall from Jersey writes, you guys rule AC at 8:45 a.m. with ONA. Hey, supposedly they do a Hootie and the Blowfish remake.
I'm sure it's crazy. It's funny how they call themselves anal cunt instead of ass cunt. Like, they go with the proper name for anus. Fucking douchebags.
Yeah, I know.
They kind of want mainstream success, but they don't.
So they go, all right, look, if we say anal, maybe MTV will pick up our videos.
Yeah.
Of course.
Maybe they'll bail out before they get the cunt and they'll think we're legitimate. Rock.
Right. You don't like it?
It stinks to high heaven.
What are you going
to
play for us next, Travis? What song?
I don't have a Hootie and the Blowfish song, but I do have the theme from Three's Company.
Oh, they do the theme from...
We're waiting for you! All right, guys, let's hear it.
I'll see. Right. Okay, so far, so good. You know it's
going to change.
I know it is.
It's fucking horse shit.
They can only go 5 seconds before they went into their format, Jimmy. Yeah, that's good.
The singer is the weak link in this band.
Observer Report made $24 million, that's it, at the box office?
It's disgusting.
That movie was way better than what I... The You know, I think Jimmy's wrong, though. Maybe one more, Travis.
Yeah.
One more.
Right,
give the title.
Do you want the title, or do you want Jim to hear the song?
No, I want the title.
All right. Yeah.
This is Your Kid Committed Suicide Because You Suck.
How do you think this one goes, Jimmy?
A lot like the other ones, but it's a little bit longer. Like, right. We know. Gotcha.
You're pissing off a lot of anal cunt fans, Jimmy. They're out there.
Yeah.
When would you play that? By the way, when would you ever play that?
When your party's over and you want everyone to leave. Clear the room fucking faster than Agent Orange.
But you know, one dopey kid would jump up and go, it's about time, and just take over the room all happy.
I'm playing some good shit.
Is it true, Eric and Philly? I can't get to the phones right now because I would have to reach, and I really don't feel like reaching right now. Eric writes, Anal Cunt put out a love album. Is that true, Travis?
Really?
I don't know if that's
what
true
wacky title is it? I love you to die, or I love your death. Something. It's, I guarantee it's something. Ho ho.
It's called Picnic of Love.
Okay, fine. Picnic of Love. I was wrong.
Some of the song titles are "I Respect Your Feelings as a Woman and a Human."
That's pretty funny.
Saving Ourselves for Marriage. Greed is Something That We Don't Need. What? I'm not that kind of boy.
That's very funny.
Like, well, what does it matter, though, if you can't understand the words,
exactly,
what the title
it's all funny,
is?
It's all, the whole thing is about having funny song titles,
right,
playing fast, well, and bellowing like an idiot.
Well, good news, they do a cover of Staying Alive. You got that one, Travis?
Oh, wow. A little disco.
How do you think Staying Alive would go
it'll start off recognizable because they know that once they go into what they do, it's like fucking train tracks. It just sounds like a train coming.
I mean, redundancy-wise,
it's the exact same noise over
but
and
they'll
over
at least help you out and go, this is the song we're playing.
Yeah. So you know, okay. Because
how long will it be recognizable?
5 seconds.
5 seconds. Yeah. All right. You got that, Travis?
No, sadly, I don't.
Motherfucker. We had a nice set up to that.
You might have it on YouTube. Damn,
did you guys hear how good that setup was?
Perfect.
God damn it. We're
none
brilliant.
Better. None
I
better.
I probably could have played just any song and told you that's what
you're
it was.
Right, you know,
yeah, that's true. This is leading to shit dick.
Look at that, by the way.
This is leading to shit dick. People are requesting shit dick on the phones, on the instant feedback.
Do you want some of the stuff from the Love album?
Yeah.
Picnic of Love?
Picnic of Love.
Okay. Do you want I'm Not That Kind of Boy or I Respect Your Feelings as a Woman?
I'm Not That Kind of Boy.
Or here's... This isn't on the same album, but right underneath those two is Ha Ha Holocaust.
Come on! They did not write a song named "Ha Ha Holocaust."
They're obviously in on the
goof. Holy shit!
They're goofing, right? Is that what Anal Cunt's all about?
They have to be. Come on now. So you can't write a song like that.
Here's "I'm Not That Kind of Boy." I hope it's good. I can't preview this.
All right. Oh, you want me to do this way?
Better than what they normally do.
I like the guitar, actually.
Yeah.
You think love's a game, whatever you wish. But for me, it's years till that magical first kiss. I'll wait until my heart's on cloud
nine.
Is
the A supposed to look like an asshole? And the C like a cunt? All right.
Oh, they're all in with their name.
Boy.
Can someone get that part in my replay? We're going to drive people nuts with that.
That is bad.
Let's go to Matt in Maryland. Matt.
Just laying in front of the door again, Matt.
guys. Anal Cunt fans checking in. Anal Cunt is completely serious. All right, Matt,
yeah,
what do
yeah,
you got?
Sure they are.
Hey, you know what's drinking in cups? The dude, for no reason, says 5-6-4-3. Get yeah. real. You know that part?
Here's yes.
The, Anal Cunt EP titled 5-6-4-3 song EP.
Oh, okay.
Weird. Crazy.
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 I better fist. I better fatalist burned. Patters gonna pat a little kid in the background fucking going crazy.
Oh, wow. Look at this. Tom in Chicago. Tom.
Hey, what's going on, guys?
I love
hey,
that man. Part. Hold on. We're doing the la-la part. Let me turn this down a little bit. What do you got there, Tom?
I'm a fireman in the suburb of Chicago. I've actually been to two suicides where Dave Matthews Band has been playing on a loop. So I think that Dave Matthews kills people.
Oh, okay.
More than Ozzy, probably.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm thinking.
No, I certainly want to fucking blow my brains out of it. I'll tell you one thing. Anal Cunt has, to me, more varied music openings than fucking dumb Dave Matthews. I wish I could have said that better. Well, I bet you every fucking mid-level manager in this place loves Dave Matthews. They probably all loosen their fucking shirts, take yes. their ties off, kick back on a Friday with a brew.
We're rocking.
You know they would take a field trip together to a Dave Matthews.
Of course they would.
Dressing casually, but they're not casual.
Yeah. Ugh. You ever chino pants?
You ever hang out with those people?
Linda Carter is singing. Is that what she's doing? Why she's going
she still
around?
Still looks fucking pretty good though, man, for her age. Holy
yeah,
shit!
Yeah, let's see if the tits held up though.
She'll be here
Jimmy.
Today.
Really?
Yeah, she yesterday. She'll be here today.
Is she coming in?
Yeah, she's doing
doing our show.
No, she's doing Judith Regis.
Oh.
She's fucking sexy, man, for an older woman. That's to be an older woman that you'd want to bang.
Let me say hi to some dude in Corpus Christi. Oh. He wants us to play. Where the fuck are you, Corpus Christi?
You want that old lady hand around your cock?
Look, I do. It's Wonder Woman.
Look at it. Look at it. Look at it.
Yeah.
No.
Look at it.
I want those wrinkled fingers in my ass in the invisible plane. You realize you're not on a plane, just landing on the runway, having an old lady finger your rear end, and the police come for you?
You're yelling, take off.
It's like, yeah, why would you want an invisible plane if they could see you? Hey, look, there she is flying through the sky in nothing. Stupid.
It certainly is. Sammy Hagar's got a new band.
Oh, I'm sure it's terrific.
We passed on them, and they're doing press everywhere.
Chicken Foot.
I guess they're doing all right, the Chicken Foot.
Yeah, apparently.
What the hell's that about?
Who they got there? Chili Peppers drummer? Right? Chad Smith is in that one.
Oh, really?
And Michael Anthony.
And Sammy.
And Sammy. And what's his name? The guitar player there.
Eddie Van Halen?
No, I don't
think. Is it Wolfgang?
Satriani, I think.
Oh, yuck.
Satriani.
What's the name of the new band?
Chicken Foot.
Why is it Chicken Foot?
Because it's called Chicken Foot.
Can we hear a little bit of it?
Do we have any Chicken Foot in there?
I'm sure it's abominable.
I want to hear their hit. It's like their new release.
No, I'm sorry, we don't.
What? How do we not have Chicken Foot?
I don't know.
Any on YouTube game?
There's got to be Chicken Foot because aren't they playing it on one of the stations here?
I'm about to take a phone call that could offend a lot of people. Warning, warning, warning.
Let's say hi to George in D.C. George?
Morning, folks.
Hey. Hi.
I saw Anal Cunt about a month ago, and they debuted a new song, and it's called Beating Up Niggers for Selling You Fake Crack.
How did it go?
Fake crack. Yeah, more or less. But it was the weirdest show because it was a strange mix of, like, there were a lot of, like, punk rock kids, but then there were also frat boys. And I didn't really understand it, but they knew more of the songs than any of the punk kids did, so.
Yeah.
Well, is it true that Phil sings on a lot of those songs, or what's his relationship with the band?
So I know their lead singer is Seth Putnam. The dude is kind of famous for overdosing and being in a coma for about 2 months, and then like not being able to walk but playing shows while sitting down and still being his completely insane self. But I don't know, they're kind of cool dudes, so.
All right. I think I'm going to do some Googling of this Anal Cunt.
A little Google. Do you have did you find Chicken Foot?
Oh, yeah.
We got to hear a little foot. Sammy. Let's see if it sounds like typical Sammy.
He's fucking horrendous.
This is down the drain. I like Sammy Hagar.
Oh, do you?
I was a fan of Sammy Hagar.
What? No, you weren't.
I was a fan of the Sammy.
Yeah, what's wrong with Sammy?
He's awful.
Sammy.
Oh, really?
Holy shit, is this fucking bad.
It's so annoying. I love when you get
annoyed. It's like
annoyed.
The B-side of every fucking album.
Listen, man. Come on. They're building up to something.
Why is he talking?
Exactly. It's just like, it's fucking awful.
For the intro. Jesus.
Sometimes you gotta roll with it up front. Some things are better left in the closet. Some things just left.
Yeah, like David Carradine.
Someone tells me this isn't the hit.
Really? Better not be, is what you're saying?
Yeah. You'll know after this verse, the chorus will come in. This is textbook songwriting.
Oh, this is brutal.
Really is droning. There it comes.
I'm not in.
Sister Dawn checking in says, sounds a little like Running with the Devil.
Yeah.
The background music does.
Yeah. Good call.
Down, down.
Yeah. It's just a retooled Van Halen song.
Yeah.
You're right. Why is Chad in the band? What's going on with the Red Hot Chili Peppers that he has time to hang out with Chicken Foot?
I don't know, but he does.
Fade out.
Yeah, yeah. Enough of chicken shit.
Chicken Foot. We like Sammy, though. He's been good to us.
That's
over
chicken.
The years.
Chicken Scoot.
Ah, yeah. Yes.
Like what that chicken was singing better.
Yeah. Yes. Chicken anal cunt.
What? Oh, you want to hear the? You want to hear the single?
Oh, is that
sure
the Chicken Foot single?
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Let's hear. Oh yeah.
It's
oh yeah.
It's called Oh Yeah.
It's called Oh Yeah.
Sammy's 61, by the way.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
No shit.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, not with the fucking woo-hoo, like having a great time before the song starts.
I hate that.
That was a David Lee Roth staple.
I say that I'll say this. His voice does sound really good.
His voice is amazing.
It's a really good voice. I can't say it's not. Lyrically, it's fucking atrocious.
You didn't like Hoochie Coochie Man?
Yeah, that was Blues Man. All right, the idea of the Blues Man. Who are you fucking? Ronnie Van Zant sang about that in 75. Stop, you're not a Blues Man.
Hoochie Coochie Man.
What is a hoochie coochie man?
I don't know.
Fucking asshole.
You might need a Wikipedia of that.
But I actually
got the nice chant. The old.
I do actually like
chant.
The song.
It's catchy.
Yeah, I don't
Sammy knows
like
how
it.
To make a catchy song.
Yeah.
I don't know if I would buy it or download it, but or whatever.
I download this one just have
would
it on
really?
The iPod.
Yeah, why not?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Literally, it's fucking stink, but
Sammy's voice is great.
Yeah.
Got range of a motherfucker, that guy.
Yeah, I get it.
No more songs about the Hoochie Coochie Man? That's what we're getting at today?
I don't know. That's your Hoochie Coochie Man! Who fuck? Why didn't somebody go, look, dude, can we change that to anything but that?
Anything.
Your Hubba Bubba Man. Your Toenail Jam Man. You know?
Jimmy hates the Hoochie Coochie Man.
Everyone hates. What is the Hoochie Coochie? Look, can you look that up, please?
It's legend.
You're Minnie the Moocher Man.
It's a blues legend.
Minnie the Moocher.
What has D-Rock got? He's in front of a
an
microphone.
Awful fucking serious satellite radio shirt.
Sorry.
And a Dickies fucking
nose.
Oh, really? What the fuck,
dude? Why are you brown nosing?
Fucking come worm.
You fucking trustee.
What are you painting Mel's office today? You want him to know that you're part of the team?
What are you doing?
I didn't know you were a brown noser. What the fuck, dude?
God damn, dude. We came from XM.
God damn it.
We used to make fun of that fucking shit.
Giant pimple on your neck.
Wasn't fortunate enough to get the serious hoodie that somebody else on our staff gets, so I got the t-shirt.
Who got that?
Look at that. Oh, by the way, want everyone to notice the passing of the buck just happened.
He's still doing it.
He was in a jam up, and he's like, "Let me usher this off to somebody else."
And you got to appreciate that.
Love to pass the buck.
Who got the serious hoodie?
Who's got the hoodie?
Primetime Sam Roberts.
Oh, Primetime Sam.
Is
Roberts.
Is he a brown noser too?
It's the worst.
Sam is a brown noser. That motherfucker.
You know all the crap we went through.
Is he wearing it?
With that fucking dog,
dude. What? Take
Remember
that shirt
shit?
Off now.
Remember that shit we went through with the dog?
Yeah.
And you fucking now wear it with pride.
Yeah, do you?
Oh, you suck.
Are you wearing it?
Oh,
my God. What is wrong with you guys?
It's like a soccer jacket.
Yeah, it's like a jogging suit.
Oh, top. I didn't even realize.
I like being over here, but that's brown nosing shit.
It's raining out, that's all.
Turn around. Is there anything on the back?
Should be a target.
Oh, the dog. God. Yeah, there you go. The dog is on
that
the
looks
side.
Good on a radio.
It's a Sirius satellite radio, the best radio on radio.
Sirius XM. I don't get it.
Where's the XM part?
It's a building. It's a building. It's a bag.
This was...
Turned into a bag.
This is one of the older ones before there was an XM.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my God.
Why I'm sure it'll be one of the newer ones if they drop the XM.
Yeah, exactly. That won't go obsolete.
Is there anything worse than brown nosers?
No.
You know brown noser out there, don't
dig
you?
Dig deep.
Sure
dig
do.
Deep with your nose. Nuzzle it right in there.
How about we take brown nosing phone calls next? We all know one.
That's right.
Fucking brown noser.
Lose the shirts, guys. Please.
Check out.
Please.
Gene the truck.
What is he saying? Oh, yeah.
Hey, Gene, what's up, man?
Hey, what's going on?
Hey, man.
Yeah, you got to check out Chickenfoot's new single. It's called We're Back and We're Better Than Ever.
That's exactly it.
Sing along.
The laughing.
We're back. Because I'm a hoochie-coochie man.
Bye-bye.
Later. Yeah, this is Jimmy.
This could be a Chickenfoot song.
Yeah.
For real.
We've been away for a long time.
This could be one of those processors.
We played some games.
Yeah.
The more things change, the more things stay the same. We're a little bit older, but we're much wiser. We're back. We're better than ever. We're back. We're back. Together forever. We're back. We're back. We're better than ever. We're back. Forever. We're back. We're back. We're back.
I like this part.
We're back. We're back.
We're back. We're back.
Yeah.
We're back. We're back.
But they'd be leaning back to back. We're Eddie would be playing and smiling, and David would be leaning like back to back.
Of course.
Wolfgang would be there smiling at them.
Yeah. We're back.
It's catchy.
It is.
And Sammy Hagar's fucking voice is still right there.
Yeah,
Sammy Hagar. I think I got to download this.
He has a lot of shit in his voice, man.
Yeah, he can sing.
And you know what? He talked to us. He said he just wants to have a good time with his music. He doesn't want to take it too serious. He wants to just write cool, fun songs, just party songs. That's what he's about.
Hoochie Coochie Man.
Could we play the original Hoochie Coochie Man? That's where it should have started and ended. I think it's an old Willie Dixon song, but I think Muddy Waters made the Hoochie Coochie Man.
Oh, he's like, should I be a blues man?
You got a little Hoochie Coochie by Muddy?
I have so many versions of Hoochie Coochie Man.
Just
whichever one you like.
Play the wrong one.
All right.
Play the absolute wrong
one. Exactly. I'm sure this isn't what you're looking for. Of course, it's not.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah. Hang on, I'll find Ellen's that. Audience clapping.
You're terrible, Travis.
Can you imagine taking this nail clipper and just fucking pinching the head of your cock with it?
Jesus.
Like, ow! Just pinching, like putting the corner in the hole and pinching.
Ow! No, I can't.
How about just clip the edge of your tip off?
Oh, wait.
I got to get involved now. You put it right over the hole and snip so it comes out like a little piece of kalima. A little ring. Oh, like my mother used to make out of fucking penis
rest
tips.
Rest in peace. She'd go down in a morgue.
She was a saint. Just a saint in the way she would make the kalamaha.
Right. Dan H. from Raleigh writes, play It's About Time from VH. It was their 2004 comeback with Sammy, and it's almost exactly like Jimmy's song.
What's it called? And better than ever?
It's called... Oh, boy.
We're back.
I think I'm getting more popular because the instant feedback just flies
by
now.
We're back.
It's About Time. It's about time.
Right. Don't forget about Muddy Waters, though. You're going to give me a little Muddy.
I have like three versions of Muddy Waters.
All right, try another Muddy.
All right.
Where's the Van Halen song?
Yeah, this is it.
Sounds like Bo Diddley.
Yeah.
The gypsy woman told my mother.
These are all the same, by the way.
Before I was born.
This sounds just a little bit.
Blues sucks
a
dick.
I got a boy child coming.
You wouldn't listen to this?
No.
Come on. Son of a gun.
I don't mind this.
I like this, actually. Bad to the bone.
Yeah, but this was before Bad to the Bone. Well, these are the real guys.
Yeah, this was.
Every one of them sounded like this.
What?
Every blues song was that.
But they were the first.
But they were the first to put it on tape, my friend.
I hate this.
Everyone else afterwards.
Redundant.
Come on. Let's roll Muddy.
It's the same old shit.
He's
a hoochie coochie man.
Okay.
Everybody knows
him. Yeah. He's good, though.
All right, enough. A little taste.
What's the Van Halen? What's it called?
It's About Time.
We're back.
they're saying it's close to what you did.
We have it?
I've never
heard a song go off the cliff faster. Like, it started off really heavy.
Yeah, yeah.
And then Eddie did that stupid wow, 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 which I fucking hate when he does. And then Hagar, again, his voice is good, but it's just nonsense.
All right.
Sammy's the take a break.
Yes.
Sammy is the shit.
That started really good, then started to suck a big fucking pile of dicks.
I might have to download. Oh,
no, you're not. Yeah. You're going to forget. No.
Oh, yeah, and that one.
We got three.
Oh, yeah.
We got three Chickenfoot songs. Oh, yeah. Get It Up and Learning to Fall.
Get It Up.
Well, now that's probably pretty sexually risque. Racy.
And now that he's 61, learning to fall, so it's perfect.
Now, at least he's got a sense of humor. God love him. This is if he laughs before the song. What's funny? Are you laughing in studio?
What's funny?
What, you got the fucking Marx Brothers on in the background?
The Marx Brothers.
Fucking asshole.
You don't like when they do that?
I fucking nothing. I hate nothing more.
They just kind of get into the feel of what
they're about to do. Yeah, a bunch of boys about to have fun. Get the fucking beers out. Assholes.
What's wrong with getting the beers out?
Nothing, but just don't laugh like, You don't need to tell me we're having fun. If I'm having fun, I'll let you know.
Oh, my God.
But then you're telling.
Well, yeah. But I'm saying I'm the one, if I'm having fun with the music, I'll let them know. You don't have to show me that it's a ball before the lyrics even start.
All right. Are we doing shit dick to break there, Travis?
Yeah, we got shit dick.
Yeah, I know you were on the same page. Why don't we do this and we do something else after that?
Da, 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 da. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Another overrated song. Sorry, Van Halen fans.
Whoa.
I live my life like this. No,
yeah, we get it.
You don't like this, eh?
I did back in 79.
All right, well, your taste changed.
I don't know.
What was Running with the Devil? Come on. Yeah, wait, now we're getting picky.
It kicked out.
The devil doesn't run. He's got big cloven hooves. His tail drags. He walks slowly.
Did you like any Van Halen growing up? I said any, not Eddie. Any Van Halen
this is okay.
Growing up.
Hot for Teachers, okay. You know, they were okay. I don't think they stink. I'm not a fan.
How about Jamie's Crying?
Who cares about her? For real. How's that go? Jamie's crying. No, it's. Why is she crying? I don't get it.
Very badly raped.
See? This is okay.
No Van Halen growing up?
No, I think they're extraordinarily overrated.
Wow.
I like their version of Really Got Me.
That's great.
That. With a little Eruption before that.
Yeah, Eruption I always thought was overrated, too.
Not for the time, my friend.
Maybe not.
Eddie was doing some things with that guitar.
They did some things with his tongue.
Oh,
he was using it as a paperweight.
Door stuff. Oh.
Is she?
All right, why don't we move on? We did a lot of music today.
Certainly did.
That's you know why we did a lot of music? Because
we're queers.
Les Paul is 94 years old today. See, that's how we tie it in.
Oh, yeah?
94 years young.
I'm 57 years young. I'll be 58 in March.
No, you have to be 58 by now.
I'm 57 years young, Greg.
You have to be 58 going on 59.
I used to babysit
now.
You.
We
of
all
course
know
you used to babysit.
I remember one time I gave you talking did. To. I told you about the birds and the bees and you ran up the apple tree.
That was my dad.
No. He went and got
and
you.
I ran up there
the
before
boys,
he came.
The boys and the bees.
Yeah, he showed you. I'm like, this is what you do to make yourself feel good.
Oh, my God.
And you're like, Uncle Holy Paul, shit. Why is it standing up straight?
And Uncle Paul said?
Oh, that's good.
Uncle Paul
I love my uncle. Was that an I love my Uncle Paul wow. bib?
Yeah, right.
Holy shit.
Where'd you find that? Is someone selling that from, like,
looks
our
like
community?
It goes around a cock.
No, I don't think so.
That's cute.
I think it's just, you know, you could put whatever you want on a t-shirt and have it hosted on a site somewhere.
Yeah.
I think Travis did that with his shitty dog. So, this is available for purchase somewhere.
Are there Dexter shirts that no one bought but you?
You know, someone bought a Dexter shirt.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's great.
How about that?
Hope they were killed in drunk driving accidents. Hit by a drunken fucking... They have a drunk, like, Mac Bowl from a truck on the front of their Dexter shirt.
We may have created a baby onesie with Dexter's picture on it, and then we may have put it up on Cafe Press. Huh? No,
How do I turn you off? Give me a button to turn you off in there.
Can't do that.
God damn it.
Can't do that.
He actually has true control, Travis.
Yeah, I know.
Yes, he does.
Hey, speaking of Jamie's Crying, I heard we almost lost Tone Loc.
What happened there?
What's the connection to Jamie's Crying and Tone Loc? Anyone?
Ah, okay.
No, Jimmy. No. You didn't do anything when you're
a wild thing, because Jamie was a wild thing.
Well, I think he sampled a little Jamie's Crying,
right?
Right. Hey, wild thing?
Yeah.
I think he passed out or something at a concert. He's still performing.
Wow. Flying.
Maybe we can find that story.
What happened?
Or maybe not. Maybe no one gives a shit.
He was big for 10 minutes.
I know.
So yeah, these are a couple of enjoyable beats.
Did you like this growing up, Ben?
Nah.
You didn't like this?
Nah, none of this shit.
Why not?
The only stuff I liked during this time was NWA and Ghetto Boys.
How about Eric B. and Rakim? You didn't like them?
No.
What, are you a criminal?
I only liked the hardcore gangster shit because it was hysterically funny.
You didn't like the pop rap?
No.
How about Big Daddy Kane?
Fuck that.
But the Fat Boys.
Parents just don't understand.
That's Will Smith. That was a little silly.
Yeah, no, little.
You're not going to get it.
How about Houdini? The Freaks Come Out at Night.
No.
How about Just Ice?
No. How about Busta Move, Young MC?
Ghetto Boys. Ghetto Boys. That was the shit.
What about Busta Move?
Nope. I didn't care about Busta No Move.
How about Run DMC?
Nope.
Jesus. Run DMC for real?
Nah, it wasn't DMC.
How about Dana Dane?
I only liked the NWA and Ghetto Boys because it was funny shit. They would sing just everything about whores, hoes, and drugs and fucking killing people.
How about Slick Rick and Dougie Fresh? And?
No.
Wow.
Dougie Fresh.
He's beatbox.
What a Fab Five Freddy.
Oh, wow, yeah. Looking for some gear to
buy. I thought more music. Rock my world. We can't stop with
God, this old very school shit is just hysterical.
Some of it doesn't hold up.
It's so old. This is like hip-hop's answer to doo-wop music. Like, compared to rock music now, this is fucking doo-wop, 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 wop, wop, doo-wop.
You're probably right. Oof. Hey, speaking of Uncle Paul.
Sure.
We have a pedo story in the paper today.
You know, when you was young.
No, not me.
It would be really hot, Greg, and you'd go, Uncle Paul, it's so hot out. So I'd make you a cumsicle.
Oh, fuck.
I'd put some cum in the ice tray and put a cigarette butt in there.
Why would that be pleasurable for anyone? Like, even the creepiest creep, why would a cumsicle?
Yeah.
Like, what the fuck, dude?
Usually Uncle Paul.
Name one person that would enjoy a cumsicle.
Note, Paul raised his hand.
Usually Uncle Paul isn't so blatant.
Well, you know, and he was very poor, and all he had was sardines in the house and papaya juice. He's a very awful diet.
Jackie's half-brother busted in kiddie porn raid. Right. This is on pretty much the front page of the paper today. Just about. Just
up
missed.
In Yemeni.
Page 2 or 3. Jackie Kennedy's half-brother, who has long lived a quiet existence in a sleepy Oregon suburb, was busted for harboring a sickening kiddie porn habit, authorities said yesterday.
As opposed to another kind of kiddie porn habit? There's the sickening ones, and then there's what?
Well, there are the funny ones.
Endearing, funny, right. Sensitive.
Well, you don't fuck the kids, you just lick their feet and run. It's kind of funny.
Oh, my God.
It's creepy, but it's funny.
Lick their feet and run.
You lick their tootsies and run. Hey, someone lick my tootsies. Mommy, that man, his mustache tickled my tootsies. Did he touch you? His mustache tickled the bottom of my tootsies. And then he made a stain in his pants and ran away. My feet smell like bad breath.
Yeah.
My feet smell like cigarettes and liquor.
That's terrible.
My feet smell like sardine oil and papaya juice.
So what did this character do?
Well, they share the same mom, this creepin' Jackie O. And this happened in October, but the paper finally got the documents, and here's the one thing you never want to happen to your house.
Uh-oh.
Computers and other electronic equipment were seized during the search.
When you see them pulling those things out of houses during the search?
When you see a keyboard poking out of a box.
A box. The guy's got rubber gloves on, and he's...
Right.
Big box with a tower in it.
Not good.
Whatever you have or ever have had, they're going to find.
They'll find it. I don't care how many times you've wiped that fucking hard drive clean.
And this guy trying to get out of it, in an interview with his local paper, he said the information about the photos is a private matter.
Yes, between me and the children.
I paint my hard drive with thermite paint. So if they show up, I blow it up because I was a Navy SEAL.
Shut up.
Do you know the panic you must feel when you hear, it's the police, and you know that you have 11 gigs of child porn.
11 gigs.
Do you know how fucking... You're probably thinking, is there one button that deletes everything forever?
Could you wait at the door?
Yeah, okay. All right, be right there. Okay.
I'll bet you panic and unplug your computer.
They'll never get it now.
Yeah. This computer's broken. We might as well leave it here and give up. We'll never catch him.
Would you try to eat your hard drive?
Dude.
What would you do?
I wonder how many people were caught just taking their computer and smashing it on
over
the
and over again as they're trying to get through the front door. In.
The monitor. Well, the hard drive is fine.
The monitor, yeah. I'll show them. The mouse, you swing it around. Throw it against the wall.
Van Halen Guitar Hero coming out at the end of the year. That's good. We got a story from Jason in Virginia. Jason, go ahead. It's the Opie and Anthony show, which you fully enjoy. Go ahead.
Good evening.
Hello.
Good evening.
That's good, Noha.
No.
Hey, they busted a guy one street over from me, and he was in his 70s or late 70s. And I don't know if Danny or anybody could find the picture of him on the internet, but he's a complete creep. His arrest photo, he has like a nasal cannula. He's on oxygen, but they busted him for child porn. So now I have like a...
Oh,
face.
Yeah, that's Larry.
Of course.
So now I have like a face to go with the Uncle Paul character, and I've got a three-year-old, and I'm completely creeped out. Jimmy, you're a sick fuck. Punching out, buddy.
All right, hey, a lot of people pissed off at the Van Halen thing. Ian Rice from Long Island writes, for fuck's sake, what music does Anthony like? I've never heard him not shit on a genre or artist.
I said I liked Van Halen back in the day.
What's your top five bands,
Anthony? The day, of course, Alice in Chains.
Alice in Chains.
Of course.
Solid. What else?
Nirvana.
Sabbath.
Mm-hmm. Chris Cornell, Soundgarden.
Mm-hmm.
I have my era.
Yeah,
I have my three-year span.
No kidding. What about old school?
Old school?
I'm sure it'll be rock.
I was kind of into the...
you like Stone Temple Pilots, too.
Yeah, yeah, STP, definitely. Mm-hmm. I was kind of into the... I got sucked up in that Southern rock thing back in the day.
You like Skynyrd?
Skynyrd.
I love
Molly
Skynyrd.
Hatchett,
not,
Charlie
not
Daniels.
So much. Not so
Marshall
much.
Tucker.
Not so much.
Fucking... All that happy horse shit.
Yeah. You went deep with the Southern rock.
Yeah.
Molly Hatchet. What's a Molly Hatchet song? I don't even know Molly Hatchet.
Do
you have a Molly Hatchet? I don't
Flood
know.
With disaster. There's whistling in the song.
I liked a couple of their songs.
I don't know what
Do we have a favorite? I don't know.
Anyone.
Okay. No, it's Flirting with Disaster.
Flirting with Disaster.
That's probably their biggest, no?
I do not know one Molly Hatchet.
You
song.
Know
heard
this.
Of this.
You know this. You know this.
Ian's instant feedback continues. Then he writes, Jimmy.
Yeah, oh no.
Eddie Van Halen blows Tony Iommi away.
Yeah, he yes, of course. Yes, sure.
Molly Hatchet.
As Jimmy sits there in an Ozzy Osbourne t-shirt, he's going to agree with you.
It's just silly. Eddie's a good guitarist, but it's like, yeah, all right, already. We got it. Eruption. Oh, yes.
You know what?
Iommi invented that.
What's weird?
Genre.
I can't think of a Marshall Tucker song. It's driving me nuts.
I know.
Like, I know
one.
This shit. I had to play this forever.
Oh, there was the General Store Blues. And then there was Bring Me a Pipe.
Wait, don't even go.
Can't You See?
Yeah, Can't You See? There you
That's
go.
Like their hit.
I knew there was a C in one of their songs. Yeah.
There's a
way to go,
the live
Travis.
Version.
Jesus.
Good work.
King of the live version.
Exactly. Fucking just that live version.
How about you choose the second one every time now?
Yeah, yeah.
And you're going to be right.
King of the live version.
Yeah.
And on your back door. And the other one, Sweet Lucy was that knocking on your back door?
Did you like Creedence?
The other one. What's the other huge one from that? Perfect Strangers.
Yes, those two.
With that guitar in the beginning.
I know. That was.
Give me a little Perfect Strangers.
Little Perfect Strangers, Deep Purple. Come on. It's fucking music day on the Opie and Anthony show.
You really are talking a lot about music.
Oh, the live version.
Are you kidding?
No.
You fucking
Look,
piece of,
we told you to pick the second one every
shit.
Time, Travis.
Yeah, you really are. You know what you are? You're a bucket
King
of
the live version.
That's
Listen.
The only reason he has a beard, so you know it's a person, not a shit bucket.
Dang. Who was the keyboard player? Wasn't it, what's his name? John
Rick
Lords?
Allen?
Who?
I think John Lords or something.
Oh, shit, I don't know that. John Lords.
I was in a gang called the Lords.
Yeah. Of course you were. This is some good
this
shit, man.
Fucking
this
rock.
Fucking rock.
We might be dating ourselves, but come on,
listen to this. Listen to this.
Can you remember? Good shit.
Remember my name?
good shit.
It was actually the other one that has the cool guitar.
Yeah.
Knocking on your back door. Built.
Look at those guys.
Now we can fade out.
There's a picture of Deep Purple.
That's good
and there's
shit.
A guy in the end with a fucking, like a light green satin jacket. It's a truck. Who keeps their hands in their jacket pocket for a band photo?
But he's not the problem. I think the guy in the middle is the problem.
With the fucking horrible beard?
Mustache.
It's the Big Lebowski. He's a creep.
They're all trying to look cool.
None of them look cool.
That picture doesn't really hold up, huh?
No, it's awful. The coolest guy is the guy with the red all the way to the left.
And
exactly, he's not
because
in the photo.
We're here. A little knocking on your back door.
Yeah.
Come on, Charles.
Well.
Let's go. Here we go. Listen to this fucking guitar.
Yeah, very ominous.
That sounds like it was done with a bow,
doesn't it?
Is that possible?
Yeah,
it
sure is. This fucker kicks in nice.
Fuck yeah. Fuck yeah. I will listen to the song every time it's on the radio. I'll stop whatever I'm fucking doing.
Of course.
I've never heard this.
No?
The real Jimmy?
I don't think so.
How'd you avoid radio for 2 decades?
How great is that?
I'm glad I did.
How'd you avoid it, though?
I would listen to it. I just always hated the radio. They would talk over the song. What I'm doing. Sweet Lucy was a dancer, but all of us were cancer because she was a samurai. She made electric shadows beyond our fingertips, and none of us could reach that high. She came on like a teaser. I had to touch her. Enjoy her little paradise.
We could do this all day, but we got to change gears. We got some great, great fucking pedo stories coming in. The good pedo stories, by the way. You know, where that might be just of age. Fucking listen to this one. John in New York. John.
Hi, Sean
from Georgia, actually.
Wow. But, sorry. Wow. They really got that one wrong.
Fucking phone screener.
It's Albany, Georgia, so. But recently down here at Albany High School, the girls' basketball team had a party at one of the hotels after the season was over. And one of the coaches at the school, not the basketball coach, just a PE coach, decided to start texting the girl and one of the girls on the basketball team and telling her that he wanted to have sex with her and all this. And he decided it was a good idea to show up to the hotel where the party was, and all the coaches were also. And he showed up with some alcohol and got fired. Oh. And I believe has charges pressed against him right now.
Oh, that's not good. You can't show up at the hotel room where the big party's going on.
No.
With the teenage girls from your high school.
I know y'all were talking about Dave Matthews earlier.
Yeah.
His song Angel will get you laid every time.
No, it won't. When they fall asleep, you just climb on and stick it in before they wake up.
Every girl thinks it's the greatest song ever made.
No, they don't. Year.
Know what will get you laid every time?
Happy birthday if you have a gun. Any song if you have the right weaponry. If you have a lead pipe, fucking crazy trying to get you laid.
Roofies will get you laid every time.
Yep.
That was the answer.
Of course.
Let's go to Mark. Mark?
Hey there. What's up, man?
Hey, Mac.
Hey, man.
Hi, Mark.
Good evening. Hey, yo. Yeah, so my friend's dad just got elected selectman of Plymouth, the message, you know, where the Pilgrims landed.
Of course.
And so
I meant the car.
I was having dinner with this guy, like, about a week, you know, before whatever. And then all of a sudden, I see his face on the front news of the local newspaper. I'm like, what's going on? Turns out he was talking to what he thought was two 14-year-old girls. Yeah, turns out a little police officer action happened. So he shows up to this Burger King trying to get a threesome going with these two 14-year-olds, sees the cops, and peels out. And then he's saying online to them, oh, you can't get in trouble for just talking. Yeah, you can. He's in jail right now.
Yeah, they all say that.
You're
in trouble for just talking. I was only talking.
There's something else going on there.
You know, when you think of pedophiles, or you look at David Carradine, or like, like when you look at people that have a high...
Why David Carradine?
Not as a pedophile. I'm saying is what he needed to get off.
Oh, okay.
Like, you know, apparently he needed to have something tied around his neck. And, like, I'm a fucking filth bag.
Did you read up on this David Carradine? His ex-wife is talking about how he came up with these crazy contraptions.
Oh, no.
For his sexual needs.
And she said it was very dangerous.
And she said she
like
would
that.
Leave him to his own devices.
Yeah.
Like, she would walk in on him and he would be building this fucking whacked out thing.
Kung fu.
Like the fucking,
more than
like
just a rope around his neck. He really got into building these things.
See, to need that to come, or to need children, or some fucking horrible deviant thing, it's almost like you feel normal when you think about like what some people need. Like, yeah, right, I want my nipples flicked. Tell me how you're going to fuck another guy in front of me. Torture me.
I need to fucking, like, a trebuchet to shoot something up his asshole. building in his garage.
One of those things that fires T-shirts out. Yeah. He has to put wads of bubblegum in that.
He's the Rube Goldberg of fucking getting off.
Very good. You know what? I can't take that call.
Take it. Why, Opie?
It's disturbing. Paramedic who went to a pedophile.
We got to hear that.
Jesus. Pedophile call.
Got to hear that.
Come on.
I want it from a paramedic?
Come on. Frank, Minnesota.
Hello?
Frank. He hung up. Thank God.
Why?
Frank.
Brian in St. Louis. Brian.
Good morning, boys.
Hey.
Happy birthday, Yimmy.
Uh-huh.
My brother's ex-lady, when they were going through divorce, accused him of having kitty pictures on his computer. Cops come out and confiscated everything, and they didn't find anything because there wasn't anything. But she just laid this shit on him because they were going through divorce. 4 years ago, he still hasn't gone back to get that computer because he's afraid of what they might have put on it.
What?
How about you just throw the computer away?
What are you doing?
Yeah, like you really need to use an old computer that bad?
Hello?
Yeah, but I mean, what does he think they did with it? Put kitty porn on and they're going to wait for him? Why wouldn't they just put out a warrant for his arrest?
Yep, he was just being a bitch and wanted to make his life miserable. There was nothing on the computer.
I know, I understand that, but I'm saying, why doesn't he just go and get it? If there's nothing on it, what is he afraid they put on it?
He doesn't know, but he is so paranoid that he, after that happened, and I mean, come on, would you like to actually accept if Uncle Paul went to a Cub Scout meeting? How would you like to be accused of that?
Is he still in the same state as he was?
Yeah.
So anything they put on his computer, if they could get him in trouble for it, they would arrest him for it now. What do you think the law says? Kitty porn if you're within 4 feet of the machine?
Hey, I didn't say he wasn't semi-retarded.
I just
said it had happened, man. And that's like, I hear Aunt bitching about his divorce all the time. I try dealing with that.
All right.
Well,
goodbye, boys.
I think I have reason to.
Goodbye, sir. Thank you.
Fall apart, sir.
Justice God made me.
Mm-hmm. All right. We got a fine home run call from our favorite
we got that one?
Announcer, John Sterling.
Were they listening to the game in real time?
Now, he finally fucked got up a call.
Do we have the one he fucked up?
Robert,
maybe we
yeah.
should play that as it a little prelude.
Travis, you still have that? Or I don't have it over here, my friend.
I have it.
You really do? Okay. He messed up this call bad, like Ant's saying.
Swung on and hit in the air to deep right center. It is high. It is far. It is gone. Oh, Hideki Matsui. He hits a three-run blast to deep right center. It's an A-bomb. It would have been if Alex had hit it. Instead, the Sayonara Kid hit it.
You fucking idiot.
It's an A-bomb.
Shouldn't he be fired for that?
Nagasaki.
Technically, in this PC world.
It's just awful.
A-bomb, you know.
It's an A-bomb. Yeah, he's talking about
Matsui. I don't think
Matsui.
A Japanese player would appreciate that.
Oh.
If something doesn't appreciate something, then you got to fire the person that said it in this world, right?
Yeah.
Thank God he didn't get fired, obviously.
If I was upper manager, I'd sit him down and go, look, we enjoy the way you call a game.
Yeah.
But if you do that one more time for any reason, you'll be fired and you won't get your pension.
Immediately.
Before the broadcast. We'll actually have someone drag you out in mid-sentence. And we'll let that fucking mushmouth Muppet finish the broadcast. Yeah. Listen, Abe, oh, God, for all the dramatic things, they just dragged John out, and he hates my guts, and it's obvious.
Not me. No way. Not once. Not never.
He's drinking from never. Cups. And Pat is smiling. He has balloon hands. I'm going to become senior real soon.
I'm the king of the trees.
Yeah, I'm a tree meister.
Tree meister.
All right, he's in George's closet. It's not his chair. Yeah. At least we know, John, who's not paying for the floor. Fucking wet mouth. What do you drink, sponges? Fucking, hey, ocean lips. Fuck! And then she tells him, no, let it go, let it run. A warmer dramatic face. You can hear the fucking spittle. She probably has a windshield wiper on her microphone. Fucking.
Oh, goddamn, that is bad.
Isn't her mouth just constantly soaked? John.
And she was running out of breath at the end.
Who's going to take up our water?
I know.
Water the rotation. She has to get the oxygen from fucking the water bubbles that are bursting in her mouth. That's how she breathes. Like some sort of a weird aquatic thing with a shitty wig. She burrows in the mud and does her broadcast.
Holy
fucking
shit.
Mud mouth.
Oh, wow.
Can we hear like one or two of her words?
Well, of course, got Jimmy. I don't know where they are. Fuck it. I don't feel like reaching today.
You want the whole thing? I can just
no, just a, just a little bit of her talking.
Give us a little taste.
Give me anything.
Roger Clemens.
This is where he won't have the live version.
And Roger Clemens is coming back.
Ugh.
Oh my goodness gracious!
Gracious.
Of all the dramatic things. Dramatic things I've ever seen. Roger Clemens standing right in George Steinbrenner's box announcing he is back.
There's a raft Roger going Clemens by with people in it because of her spittle.
And there we go, John. You don't have to worry about who's going to take that spot.
It is wet. It is damp.
You should see what's going on in the Yankee dugout. Big grin.
Yeah.
On
Pettit's eating a peanut. Posada's leafing through Highlights magazine
Roger
and jerking off.
He's now a Yankee. Attention, fans. He is here.
Derek Jeter is ignoring some nobody comedian.
I cannot fucking get enough of that because she just.
I'm on the Yankee dugout. Let me paint the picture for you. It's nothing going on.
It's the worst thing.
The water cooler's got water in it, and the bench is still where it was yesterday.
The phone to the bullpen is on the hook.
Bunch of gloves in the little glove storage areas.
And the greenskeepers, the field keepers, whatever they're called, are coming out to cover the field from my spittle.
The best part is she has a heavy Boston accent.
Oh, yeah.
And she covers the Yankees.
George Steinbrenner's box.
What a terrible fucking war correspondent she'd be.
Can we search out brand new Susan Wallman clips? I think it's about time.
We have to.
She must get excited from time to time.
They're raising the flag here on Iwo Jima. But no, she wouldn't get the key part. During the Tet Offensive in Vietnam. Oh, my God! It's supposed to be cloudy, but it's actually nicer out. Everybody's boots are muddy. We won't have to worry about what kind of weather we're getting in the jungle today.
She is the worst.
Oh, her fucking giant wet leaf lips.
Oh, shit.
She cries.
Oh,
come on.
We might have a new Susan Wallman.
During the Joe Torre.
I don't know how good this is.
Yeah, so. It's about Joe Torre, I think.
No way.
Oh, I think we played this.
No way.
Let's hear it.
I think when they were knocked out of the playoffs or something like that.
Or when Joe was...
Yankee post-game show. All right, let's play and see where it goes.
The first question was about his future. He didn't want to talk about that. He said, I told the players I was so proud of what they did. They were in a hole. Sometimes you get complacent. Sometimes you forget how hard it is. We didn't forget. And then he said something that everybody in the room all looked at each other. He said, this Yankee team has a great future. It's got a lot of young kids. There is no question about the ability of these people. They're very impressive. He said, you think it's going to last forever. And this is rough. He's your friend.
Oh, shut up.
He said,
my prostate hurts.
This has been the best 12 years of my life.
All right.
I wouldn't miss this for anybody. Now, I was okay, actually, until I went into the clubhouse, and the coaches...
I saw somebody's cock.
Yeah, exactly. Gary Sheffield hit my mouth with his cock.
The tears that you hear in
Goose Gossage put his mustache on my clit.
Are coming down the faces of the coaches in that coach's room.
Well, Susan,
and Rivera threw a fastball at my anus.
In life, unfortunately, all good things come to an end.
Really? That's very poignant, John. All good things come to an end.
6 World Series appearances, 4 championships... And 12 postseason appearances.
I guess she'll be broadcasting
years.
Forever.
And
now now they're quoting on a fortune
and
cookies. Well, you know, Susan.
Patient.
Good things come to those who wait.
Confucius say, my lucky numbers.
Yes.
She with big tongue will have wet pants.
One more thing. I can say out here. I don't know if he wants. I think he does.
That's phased out.
That was talking about. That was her.
When the inevitable.
Just yapping.
Yapping and yapping.
What was, but Joe Torre, that was the most meaningless quotes ever. He said they're all a bunch of good kids, and they got bright futures.
And what did he say about his 12 years? Like, I wouldn't have missed this for anything?
Exactly.
Of course not.
What else would you be doing? Ruining the Mets again?
It's a dream. It's a dream life. What is he supposed to say in that position?
Exactly. At least he said, I'm sick of lying on my side and my stomach because my hiney hole hurts.
Well, here's John Sterling. His latest home run call that we hate.
Yeah.
There's just tons of these things.
A switch hitter batting left, pitch. Swung on, and there it goes to deep right. That ball is high. It is far. It is gone. Oh, Nick Swisher has driven a 2-run home run to deep right center. Why, he's Swish-alicious. His 2-run blast gives the Yankees a 3-0 lead.
Do the bit. Do the bit.
No way. No way.
No way.
This is garbage.
Are you kidding me?
Swish?
He's Swish-alicious?
Swish-alicious.
Is that his thing for this guy?
That was my nickname.
Ugh.
Yeah.
It's like, as a Yankee fan, how can you enjoy... listening to that broadcast. That Michael Kay was pretty good. How can you enjoy that?
Is deplorable what he said there.
It's not funny. It's not compelling.
No.
It's not cool.
It's
just stinks.
Horrible.
Yeah, that's a bad one.
God almighty.
Oh, I thought little Nicky was coming.
Where is little Nicky?
We missed little Nicky.
This guy who's the most awkward walk I've ever seen.
Well, he's like, old swivel hips. Can't forget him.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Oh, my gosh. Should we take a quick break and then we'll wrap up?
Oh, my God.
I guess Danny's watching Lockup, huh?
Is that like there's a big tent in front of his pants?
No, actually, I haven't been watching it. It's just this clip. I was rooting around for some material this morning, and I came across
rooting.
This clip, and I just thought it was very
funny. It's kind of a slow day in the news, really. I think we got to spank North Korea. But
I've really had enough of that fucking little weirdo.
Fuck.
Yeah.
Now he's threatening what kind of nuclear shit?
Aggressive nuclear action or as use an offense.
Other word, let like, him try. The way you wind up blowing himself up, the dummy. His missiles barely fucking work. I'm sure his nuclear bomb doesn't even work.
South Korea, some big company is pulling off the border that they were on. They've had enough of him, too. The whole world has had enough
of
him. Why
would you be on the border with your business? That's got to be just...
I know.
Nerve-wracking.
Yeah. I call it the 39th parallel.
Yeah.
38th parallel? Yeah, 38th parallel.
What could you sell that you need?
You think you're having fun? You think they have fun on the border over there?
No.
No.
There's no fun going on. There's a lot of binoculars and a lot of guns pointing at you.
You think there's a lot of binocular shops?
Lots of binocular shops. Ye olde binocular shop.
How do you get from
Shoppy.
From north to south?
You got to go through Checkpoint Charlie. Checkpoint Charlie.
Practice.
Yeah, or if you run for it,
oh, that's smart.
Shot.
Well, those borders are usually very wide. That's the problem.
Yeah, that's what it is.
If it was one little line, you'd have a lot more people.
They call
by.
It no man's land in there.
By mines.
And, yeah.
How
mines,
long is it?
Barbed wire.
If you want to go from North Korea to South Korea, how long is it for real? The line.
It's got
to
be 5-6 feet.
You think? I would have thought longer.
Not longer. I'm talking with, obviously.
When we were in Cuba, me and Jeff Ross stood on the U.S.
You
side.
You weren't in Cuba ever, Jimmy. You're not allowed to go there.
We were in Guantanamo Bay.
No, you weren't.
We were looking into the...
Oh, I got a shirt from you from there.
Yes, you did.
I like wearing that shirt.
As we were looking at the Cuban soldiers, And I they might have been a quarter of a mile, half mile.
Hi, boys.
Yes.
See, the checkpoints themselves are...
Wait, it's one long field?
Very big, but then there's that no man's land in between.
That's the field that you have to run across to get to the other side?
I don't know. Oh, never God. Been there.
What if you serpentine?
Yeah, you could try to serpentine.
If you serpentine,
as they follow you with fucking ridiculous machines.
Hey, it worked for Peter Falk. I think you could serpentine right over to the
serpentine
right over to South Korea.
What's that mean, serpentine?
To run like a snake.
Yeah, serpentine.
Oh, like I thought it was just so to run straight and make hissing sounds.
Jimmy,
in-laws. Your tongue out.
In-laws. Oh. One of the best comedies ever. One of the best comedies ever. In-laws.
I haven't seen it in too long to make a judgment right now. I'll have to watch it again.
Oh, I saw that video. John in Philly. He hung up. Danny, did you see the video of the Indian guy on top of the train? Go to... fuck did I see it? It might have been on Break. Might have been on Break.com. Like, you know how they like to pile people on trains?
Oh, pile people on trains,
and then they start, like, going on top of the train?
Yeah.
If you could find... Let me see.
Please tell me... They came to a low bridge or
Dude,
a sign
wait till
or
you see
something.
This.
Come on.
We'll turn you on to the video if you haven't seen it before. Right? We got to find it, though. If someone out there knows exactly where we can find it, that would be great. Instant
Fantastic
feedback. That shit. Now, keep going. I'll know it when I see it. Ah, fuck me. It's not Break. God damn it. Was it Dig? Was it Google Videos? Was it...
Big titted monster?
Was it SaveTheTitMonster.com?
SaveTheTitMonster.com.
If you're just tuning in, we got SaveTheTitMonster.com up and running. We're hoping for national exposure, but I think the name of the website's really going to fuck us over.
Yeah, that could fuck us up. We're like anal cunt. We fucked up with the name.
Anybody?
Drunken stepfather.
You know, instant feedback hasn't reloaded in an hour. We lost
Jesus
that.
Christ. What's going on there?
Oh, Drunken Step, father or daughter. I always forget the name of it. Father is a great website, yeah.
Yeah, it's a good one.
And we lost the instant feedback, too. Another problem tonight.
Oh, really?
So, yeah.
Really?
Yeah. There are minefields between North and South.
No, yeah, of course.
Anybody know where that video is? Fuck.
What video we got?
Motherfucker.
What's it, Indian guys on train?
Yeah. Oh, you saw that?
No.
No.
Think maybe
it's on top of the train.
Google.
Hi, Mars.
Little Google.
We lost instant feedback. Don't come over here, though. It's all right. It's too... it's a small space.
It's a small space. What is that chick doing with her tits just hanging out in that picture? Jesus.
Well, if you were young and you had,
falling out a window.
Dude, if you were young and you had nice tits, wouldn't you just be like all about showing them off?
Apparently not.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, girls think differently.
We certainly do. Yeah, we never find that.
All right, let me see. I got to hang up on everybody because we're trying to find this video.
Oh, Opie.
I'm sorry to everyone I just hung up on.
Sorry.
Should we take a break and by the time we get back, we'll have it?
Yes, I got a whiz.
Oh, you think you got
it? I think I might have it. Hang on.
Yeah, let me see, Dan. Hang on. What do you got over there? All right, explain what's going on. Pause this first.
Okay.
All right, they're loading a train.
All aboard.
It looks like it's India. I don't know. And people are getting into the train, and now people are trying to get a free ride like we saw in... I forgot the name of the
fucking... Slumdog Millionaire.
Slumdog Millionaire, where they like to ride on top.
Yeah.
So there's a guy on top being all cocky trying to like get some other people on top of the train, and now push play there, Dan. You do see the wires right above his head.
Oh, shit.
You do see the wires.
No fucking way.
You do see the wires.
The high voltage wires that...
And they're laughing. Whoever's filming this video is laughing.
Run the train.
As people try to get on the roof of the train. And this guy's not really helping them anymore. And then he just walks, touches...
Oh!
Here we go.
Wow, is he dead?
He's smoking.
He's smoking dead.
And there's blood.
And no, that's fire, too.
His head's on fire.
His head's on fire.
Holy shit.
Is that sick? And watch that guy takes a quick look before he boards the train. Like, he assumes the train's going to, like...
Yeah, it's going to leave on time.
It's going to leave on time.
Still on schedule? I got to see that
the
again.
The guy's on the roof, and he just reaches up.
We'll link this video. Dead.
Boy, does he just fall right down, huh?
He gets two shots and just drops dead instantly, and then there's a fire shooting out of his skull.
What, he was just gesturing and he touched it?
His head
yeah,
is
he
on
didn't mean
fire.
To touch. I think he meant to touch it thinking it wasn't, you know, going to do anything.
His head is on fire.
Look at this guy
fire.
Taking a look before he boards a train. Like, yeah,
burning. Wow.
Bam. Bam. He hit it with his arm first, and then he fell into it with his head.
Is that what happened?
Yeah,
he got two shots.
Bomb.
Because the first shot killed him.
You could see the first shot is
the first
arm.
Shot killed him.
The second one hit him in the head. That was his head right there.
Oh my boy!
And the way he falls and his arms are straight up, that instantly killed him. He never fucking knew what happened.
You don't think he thought anything?
Nothing.
He never knew
his
what
head.
Happened.
You know how
probably
bad
right
he
had there, right, like right when he
oh, the
touched
first one
it.
Got him.
He thought like something's
right
wrong. The big flame.
Boink.
Oh, does he go down?
Down goes. I know, and I was trying
Hassan.
To.
Hassan.
Down goes strap hanger. Look at his head.
And then
his fucking
on
head
fire.
Is burning.
On fire.
How does your head catch on fire? It's not very flammable.
And smoke's coming out of his chest?
Yeah.
Wow, is that fucking... Electricity is a bitch.
No one's going to get him.
What are you going to do with him?
I'll tweet that shit.
The hell was he thinking?
Why did that guy stop filming?
Yeah, that runs a fucking train.
Yeah.
The power in there has to run a fucking train.
How many
Or if you
want to
find
that?
It yourself, it's Cuidado, Cuidado, Cuidado.
12, 13 volts.
I'd believe you. I don't know anything about electricity.
No, I would assume that is a lot of fucking voltage.
Is that like the third
no
rail?
Clue.
Is that like the third rail?
Yeah, exactly.
Like if you just touch that, you're dead instantly?
Yep. Done.
All right.
Wow.
Bam, bam. That must have just blew a fucking chunk out of his head, too. Just
had to.
Blew, explode a chunk out of his head.
Do you think he touched it, like, twice because, like, when you touch electricity, it's, you get stuck to it?
No. He kind of, like, fell.
Yeah, he hit it with his hand. He was done.
No, what it was.
At that point, and he fell into it with his
he
head.
He reached up to grab it. That got him, and then I think he was sort of pulling it down, and then it hit the top of his
did
head.
Did he reach to grab it, or did he just touch it by... I think he just had his hand
well,
over his head.
Well, he was walking on the top
I
of the train.
I think he was walking. He used it, like, to guide himself,
yeah,
I think. Thinking it was a fucking, what, a railing up there?
Amazing.
Oof.
But
that's fucking hideous.
That cooked him.
Wow.
In a microsecond, every fucking thing he ever, like, wanted to be, everything, like, every homework assignment he made or didn't
homework.
Make, and... But you know, I think
done.
His whole life, go through his whole life.
See, look.
Ended in a nanosecond.
That's right. He grabbed it kind of to guide
him. He grabbed
him
to kind of guide himself.
As he's walking on top of the train. And then
look
going
he's
forward.
Lit up.
I think it actually pulled it down a little bit, and then his head
yeah,
hit.
Yeah, and then his head hit.
Wow.
Right there, his head hits. Look,
his head's on fire.
His whole body's on fire right there.
Yeah, that thing went right
he's
through.
He's grounded. That power is going from him, from that wire, through him to the fucking train.
He's a hurting dude
he is
right there.
Just, he is the weak circuit breaker. He is a fuse. He has become a fuse, a living fucking fuse.
His head's on fire and his leg's on fire, too?
Yeah.
Oh, it shoots right out
his
of
his whole
you.
Body is on fire right there.
220.
And the fall with the arms are just like.
220,000 watts. Let's go to Paul in India. Paul.
Yeah, hey, man. How you guys doing?
This is in India, right?
Yeah, it is because actually I'm just sitting here listening to you guys, and the guy, he's saying "mar gaya, mar gaya." What that means is he's dead. He's dead.
Wow.
So,
very observant.
So, I mean,
are you?
Yeah, so, huh?
No, go. I'm sorry, Paul.
Yeah, so I mean, I'm just saying it is India, definitely, because I understand the language, and it is 220 volts. So that, I mean, over here in North America is 110, over there is 220. But it's kind of different. I don't know if Anthony knows anything about it. If you touch the wires over there, I don't know why would you, but if you do, by any chance, you would get just thrown away.
Wow.
Yeah, it explodes you.
Yeah, yeah.
Amazing.
Any other electricity videos? That's fun.
You like watching those people get zapped?
But it's so, how come the electric chair, when they kill you and the state kills you, why do they have to keep...
Because they don't want your fucking head catching on fire and pieces of you being blown out.
Why do they
can probably kill you a lot faster, but I think they do that to, you know, keep you from exploding.
How about they just stand you on a metal floor and they soup it up to 220 and you're dead in a second?
And then just... Bam!
Yeah.
Lots of amperage.
They would argue that it hurts
Anthony?
You somehow.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, hey, I'm actually originally from India. I was listening to you talking about Desert Eagle when I came here a few months ago.
Uh-huh.
And I went to Vegas 2 days ago. I actually went to the range.
Oh, you sure went?
Yeah, I did, man. The funny thing is, you know, they give you those target, you know, those pictures there?
Oh, what do they put, the Middle Eastern guys?
No, actually, they actually had the one with the hostage and two culprits. I missed all of them.
Oh, shit. You missed them all?
What was this?
Yeah. They're such a kid. Like, the kickback is unbelievable, man, you know?
Yeah, it's kind of, you really got to get used to shooting that one.
Yeah, but I mean, I just called him. I love you guys, man. I come here all the time. And, first thing I do is hook up my XM and listen to you guys, man. You guys rock.
Oh, thank you, Paul. Our Indian friend, Paul.
Sure. Hold on. Danny found a video of a guy. Yeah. Is that a fish tank, Danny?
No, it's grapes. This video's been floating around for a while. It's just, I never pulled it because it's in Spanish. So it makes sense now because you guys are watching electrocution
videos.
Why
would there be electrical grapes?
I don't know. I think it was part of, like, the lighting system.
Oh, okay.
And, like, something just was exposed or whatever. He just touched it in the wrong area.
He's at some kind of a function.
He makes a great little sound, though.
Oh, does he?
Temple. Ding.
Is he alive?
Yeah, I think he was all right.
Wait, the grapes are hanging from some kind of wall, and there was electricity going through?
Yeah,
them?
I don't really know. It's a weird setup.
It looked like some kind of a function.
And then he was touching the grapes.
Estas mais de mesa. Aqui do lado, Pederneiras. Aqui, por exemplo, tem...
Let go, you...
I know you can't let go.
How bad? He
shit and pissed himself.
How bad do you want to let go when you first touch something like that?
Mind is saying is open your hand.
Please open your hand.
God damn, that's funny. Something. Holy shit.
Let's talk to someone who works for Amtrak. Dave in D.C. Dave?
Hey, I work for Amtrak in D.C. The PAM wires are 17,000 volts, and it's pretty much instant dead whenever you touch it. I'm an electrician, so.
Oh, yeah, you're done.
How about if you had a wrench and you touched the metal to it and you were holding the wrench?
Dead.
We had a guy last year. He was climbing up a ladder. He put a ladder up against one of the engines and was trying to cut a ground strap on the pantograph, the thing that goes up and down to touch the wires and get the voltage to the train. And he climbed up there, put a wrench, the die cutters on the ground strap and blew him off the train. It blew him like 20 feet, something like that.
People who do work on those wires for a living, how do they know that they're off?
We cut them out. There's switches that we can throw, and it'll put a ground strap up to it and cut it out of the circuit.
You ever see the guys that work on those real fucking high towers where they bring them over with the helicopter?
Yeah, and they have like some kind of metal, like a rod that kind of directs electricity towards it so that they could safely work.
Yeah, really? The guy actually has to get out on this plank on the side of a helicopter and take this rod and discharge the wire with this fucking metal rod before they could drop him off on the wire.
Wait, what's he do?
He works on those high tension wires, like the real fucking tall towers. They go up hundreds of feet where like major fucking electricity is going through these things. And the guy like comes out the door and he's on this platform, this thin little platform, and he takes a metal pole and discharges the wire.
But how does that discharge it?
It's hooked to a strap or something. Here's the guy. Look at this sick shit this guy is doing.
This is his job?
This is this guy's fucking job.
Hey, man.
He's on the skid of this little helicopter going up to work on these
better hope the helicopter
these power lines that are, you know, a couple of hundred feet in the air, these fucking things. And they got to stop the copter close, but not too close, or else it'll arc to the helicopter. It's like a weird fucking thing going on.
Because electricity's right on the outside of it, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So
look at what he does.
He has a wire.
Yeah. And he's got to, like, touch the fucking... See? Bah, bah, bah.
He's touching... He's got the wire next to
it. What he's doing is he's putting the charge into himself. The wire is off. And he's putting the static charge into himself. The same to... So he's positively charged. And now he can get on the wire in this little fucking seat
Get the fuck out of here.
And work up there. That's what he does.
He just shocked himself?
He actually made himself positively charged. So he's the same as the wires.
Is that healthy for your organs?
How could it be? And now he's just hanging from a helicopter, and now he steps off the copter. He's on the fucking wires, and this is his job. He better make $1 billion.
Hold on a second. Now, is
and
he...
then the helicopter
And the helicopter has to leave.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
How much do you think his health insurance is?
Oh, forget about it.
Wait, now he's hanging in between.
Crawling
on the wires.
It's the dumbest thing I've ever seen. What job is this?
Wouldn't you just go back and go, I took care of the wires? And there's another guy on the other wire.
How you doing, Fred? Hi, Tom. they're passing each other on the wires.
He's crawling on his hands and knees, but in between two wires, probably, 70 feet in the air.
Is it easy to do that, you think?
No! How could it be? There's fucking electricity going through you.
Oh, they're picking up the other guy now.
And they're picking up the helicopter guy. He's picking up the other one.
So he's obviously, he's tied to it. So if he falls,
So he's going over by the tower, by the insulator.
And now what is he going to do
there? They drop you off on the middle wire.
Yeah, in the middle of the wire, because they can't drop you off by the insulator. So now he's got to do some work over there. Now you see the electric charge? Now he's recharging himself so he can touch the helicopter.
Get the fuck out. What if you forget one of the steps?
You're fucked.
You have a long fall.
Yeah.
So wait, is he cutting through electricity?
No, it's just discharging. Even when you shut the power off of those lines, they're still charged with static electricity.
So the power's off.
The power's off, yeah. It's really fucking sick.
I'd love to know the first guy they brought up to do that who just said, it's off, I'm okay. He had on a fucking metal hat.
How do they find this out there, Danny?
Lineman says I got it wrong. I might. I don't know. I watched the show and I was amazed.
Okay.
Go to John from Philly.
Just Google a high voltage wire worker.
Okay, good.
That guy. Okay. Yeah, Frank, what's up?
Hey, I skydived with a guy that decided to climb up the high tension tower when he was about 7 years old and swing from one of the wires. And he fell about 75 feet and eventually lost his arm. And the guy's not quite right in the head, if you know what I mean.
Oof.
Who are those guys that work? I saw a show. It was on Discovery or one of those. The structure is 2,000 feet. It's almost twice the height of what the Twin Towers were. And it's a radio tower. It's a very thin. We've seen all the radio towers.
Yeah.
But there's a big transmitter on the top, and when they have to replace that, what a motherfucker of an operation it is. You're 2,000 feet in the air. Tied to something that could just fall off.
Fuck.
John and PA, we're going to learn a little more about this. John?
Hey, Ant. Just want to correct you there. That wire is energized.
It's a live wire?
It is a live wire. And what they do with the helicopter, when he connects to that wire, he has the same potential as that wire. If they get within 10 to about 15 feet of the pole standard, they're going to ground. They're dead. So they're actually putting the energy field around the entire helicopter.
Oh, right. Yeah, okay. Now I remember that because I saw it a while ago. Yeah, they're putting the entire energy field around the helicopter.
Correct.
How sick is that?
Or if he reached out while he was working on that and touched the tower, he's instantly smoked.
Right.
Wait.
It's usually those wires are 250 KVA, 250,000 volts.
So do they stop the power when he has to work on it?
Say that again, Jim?
Like when they have to, say he has to do something on those wires, they don't turn the power off?
No, they can't. They would shut down, they could, some Holy of those supply shit. Major cities like New York City. There's
so
no
he's got to work on live wires.
Yes, sir.
But they gotta charge like the helicopter and the guy first.
Correct.
So he goes up there. What would you do on a live wire? Like, what would he have to do? Why would he go, all right, you got to drop him off in the middle there. What would he have to do?
Well, they might be changing the insulators out. Possibly one might got hit by lightning or something like that. Or they just have to shore the wires up again, check connections, make sure everything's cool.
So does he feel weird or a little off while he's doing that? Or does he feel perfectly normal?
That I don't know. I don't deal with that much electricity, so... I would imagine it would probably tingle a little bit.
Like, is your hair standing up? Do you feel stupid?
Feel stupid. He's wearing like a ridiculous suit too.
Yeah.
Yeah, and plus they're at, you know, 150 feet in the air. They can also fall.
Well, that's how he seems like he was chained, tied up to the thing with a sort of a pulley.
Yeah, you know, those never fail.
How about the nerves of the helicopter pilot? That's, he's got to be one hell of a pilot to keep that thing steady.
I'd be fucking out of my mind.
Yeah, all right, punch it out, boys.
Good job there. Good call,
that's
John.
Sick shit, man.
Mm-hmm. That within 13 feet, you can feel your hair stand up on you.
God damn.
I want to see a video, if we have it, of the guys.
Oh. What kind of job is this?
I don't, why would you do, like, who looks up at those wires and goes, boy, I want to sit up there with a wrench or a fucking hammer.
And it's right by a nuclear power plant. Look at this fucking, these guys just love danger.
It's amazing how women will fuck cops. All you ladies should do is blow maniacs like this. If you want a man's man, fuck firemen. This guy goes up on live electricity and fucking hangs out.
He's just swinging off a helicopter, heading toward the
getting
live wires.
On electrical towers.
You can see the nuclear power plant right there.
In the background.
What does he do for fun?
He's got all the features.
How do you stimulate yourself after you do this for a living?
Just fucking stick your tongue into light sockets.
Yeah. He's only having fun if he's playing fucking, if he's like having a catch with some old dynamite. That's his idea. I want to see footage of those guys that change out those radio tower things. Those guys are 2,000 feet in the air.
Jesus.
It's terrifying.
Someone wants to know, how did the birds stay on the lines?
Don't they get shit zapped?
Ground.
No, what?
They're not grounded.
They're just flying from the air?
Yeah. It's like if a wire falls on your car and you're sitting in the car, you're fine. But the second you step out and touch the ground and the car, you're fucked.
But that's what we would do. Every single one of us would get out of the car.
You're supposed to stay in the car.
Oh, fuck.
Unless the car's on fire. Then you got to take a flying leap from the doorway to the ground without touching the car.
So wait, if you open the door and you jump out and you're in midair for a split second, then you land on the ground, you're okay.
Then you're all right.
In midair.
Yeah, yeah.
But if you step out,
as long as it doesn't arc, as long as you're far enough away where when you touch the ground, it won't arc between you and the car. Like, you could get shocked without exactly touching it.
You can open the door all the way. How far, though?
They tell you just stay in the fucking vehicle. You got to get away fucking, I don't know how far, but.
More than 2 feet?
Yeah, I would say. It depends on, you know, how much voltage is.
Just drive away. What the fuck are you hanging out for? Talking.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, we're out. Ron and Fez next.
Yes.
Mars has to get in here and do some maintenance. The instant feedback is down, and I don't know. He's got to do some tweaking here.
Wreck.
Marcel S. had a great line when we were talking about Uncle Paul and old school rap.
What happened?
And he's from Rhode Island. He writes, Uncle Paul should sing, parents just don't understand.
Uh-oh. Yeah, they sure don't.
Hey, you want to play Kevin from Connecticut shitting into cups?
Yeah, that was fun.
Yeah, let's play this as we leave today. We're digging that drinking out of cups. Yeah. And Kevin did a show version
of that thing.
That's very good. We're going to meet Felice Johnson tomorrow there, Danny.
All right.
Don't forget. We meet Felice Johnson tomorrow.
No way.
No way, no hell.
No how.
This is Kevin from Connecticut doing a good job for the show. We'll see you guys tomorrow.
What does this guy think? He's an angelfish? Is he a goddamn asshole? What the fuck is he doing? Not ever. No way. Now he's Kenny Angelfish face. Hammering away like he's friggin' Tommy Throwdown. What the hell's he doing? Thinks he's got it going bossa nova. No way. No way. What is this garbage? What is this? Oh, I'm king of the boners. I'm the Cialis Meister. I show you my tent. Well, sometimes I fruncus like the Burka. Yeah, right. Yeah, right. This guy's a faggot. This guy's some sort of faggot hoagie on the Friggy ride. This guy thinks he's Captain Mayo. Thinks he's Captain Garlic Butter Sauce. When everyone needs some halitosis, they go to him. Bullshit. Bullshit. He's such a bitch. Thinks he's Miss Cinnamon. Shitting in two cups. Being a bitch. I better fist. Little twink in the background fucking going crazy. Who's this guy? Mr. Hobo Kisser? Mr. Man Kiss? No way. No way. Get real. Like those things. Mr. Hallway. Mr. Run Down Me on the Hallway. Lead me to the studio. Fuck you. 5643. You're right. Here's some hair plug, bitch. Who pays for that gun? Not me. No way. Never paying for no gun ever again. Not once, not never. Nope. Whose pair of capris is that? Who brought that goddamn flame shirt here? That's not my blouse. Not my blouse, not my problem, that's what I say. No way. Stupid foundry. Stupid logo. Satellites rule. If you don't like the satellite, you suck. What is this? Captain Giveaway? What, a money party? Who didn't invite me? Why didn't I get invited, Timmy 10 grand? What is this? Get real. I'm in love with the outcasts. I'm in love with them. They're so beautiful and cute. I'm in love with the rejects. They're fucking unreal. I love them. They're like all the Wednesday tits. I love them. I love boobs. I love looking at them. I love decoupage. I love decoupage things. I love things with wiffle ball bats and phones on them, like blankets and towels and little bags. I love them. O&A forever.